anniversary, baby. Got you on my mind. Happy anniversary, baby. Got you on my mind.
Hey, Tuesday night, and that is right. Anniversary. Happy anniversary, baby. Jimmy, happy anniversary.
Happy anniversary. 1 year of chaotic madness of the Roy and Jimmy thing on kaoticradio.com. How are you, buddy?
Man, awesome. I was doing real good until I saw it walked in the door a minute ago.
Yeah, that is no shit.
Yeah,
that,
everything was like on the up and up. We already have guests lining up. There's people here already. I got people wanting to make phone calls. I mean, you have people calling, and we have that shit walk in the door.
It's chaotic. That's what it is.
It's chaotic, man. That's cool. A big shout out to kaoticradio.com for letting us do our stuff here, man. This place is awesome. And we get a little misty-eyed here.
Well, how many guests have we had?
Did you count them?
No.
Shit, I thought you were going to like pop off with it.
Over 40.
Yeah, we had some repeats and over whatever. And yeah, ton of guests, ton of good times. And just look forward to this every Tuesday night. You guys make it all possible. Chaotic makes it possible. And then everyone that listens does the other part. And Jimmy and I get to hang out and just have fun with our boys. And that's it ain't any better than that.
And a couple gals.
Yeah, yeah. Oh, I forgot. We might have one drop in tonight, too.
Excellent. That'd
be great. I forgot. I wonder if she's going to make it.
Before we get going, though, to listen to our show tonight and every other show on chaoticradio.com, go to the new revamped chaoticradio.com app, available on iTunes and available for Android. You listen live. It is simple to use, great interface. You'll love that. And also listen live on chaoticradio.com, of course. But if you can't catch any of the shows live, they're all on iTunes. Podcast, subscribe, review. It's very important. Review what you like. Even if you don't like it, give us some. Give us some. So listen at any time.
If you don't like it, there's something wrong with you.
Absolutely.
Man, we already got a call?
Within the first few minutes.
Gee, this is going to be crazy tonight. Let's go. Line one, you're on the air.
Yeah, I'm calling for Victor Vasquez.
Ah, Jesus. It's our show. Who's nice this? Talking to you.
Who's this, buddy?
This is Frank.
Hey, Frank, how you doing, buddy?
Now, what's your real name?
It's Frank.
No, mijo. They want to know what your placa is.
You need to know what your placa is.
Oh, you don't want to know nothing about that?
We do, because everyone that calls for Victor has to let us know what their placa is.
What is my placazo?
Yeah, go ahead. Just say the name that represents your neighborhood. Just say it. Say your little...
Oh, placo.
There you go.
Obviously, our buddy Victor Vasquez is in studio. He'll help us celebrate our one-year anniversary. Welcome back, buddy. Thanks for coming in.
Congratulations.
Thank you, man.
Hey, thanks, man.
And our buddy Ernie Avila is here. He's been on a couple times. Great comic, great friend of ours. Thanks for coming in, buddy.
Thank you very much, Brad.
Well, I hope you guys keep up the good work and keep your head up.
That's for you, man.
No, that's for you guys.
That's for you.
No, that's for you guys. That's Frank. He goes all the shows. That's Frank Morales. He listens to you guys, and he also goes all the shows.
Was he at the last one?
No. He didn't make the height limit. But
oh, sorry. you weren't tall enough to ride that ride?
I guess so.
No, but you know what? Frank goes to all my shows at San Fernando all the time. And
Then I've seen him.
Yeah, you know who he is. He always goes with his wife right there on the side.
Absolutely.
He's always sitting next to my homegirl, Anna. They're always at the same table.
That's right. I remember you, Frank.
Yeah, I'm the tall Mexican.
That's it.
Nice. All right,
guys. Well, you guys the best. I'll call you guys another day.
Hey, please do, man. Thanks for listening.
You guys take care.
All right, brother. Thank you. Look at that. We're not even in a minute.
Right off the bat.
Victor's people show up.
Of course they do.
Yeah, well, they come out in droves.
He's got the best supporters, and therefore the best supporters for us. They always call in and flock. It's just great. I did want to say, though, Ernie, thanks for the Coors Light, my friend.
Oh, no problem.
Yeah, I'm sipping on one right now, and I'm not getting...
A reaction.
So I might be hammering this Coors Light tonight.
It's a birthday beer that I wanted to give you guys to celebrate
a fine birthday beer.
I always see that you're drinking Coors Light. That's why I thought of you. And then I'm like, well, I don't know what Roy drinks, but I'll bring him an Arizona.
Well, you know, I've expanded from 2 years of doing the Coors Light straight. I've actually got into Pacifico on tap, if you can find it. That's hard to find.
Yeah, it's hard to find, but it's
Pacifico
so good.
on tap is amazing. Modelo Especial on tap.
Yeah. Negra on the bottle.
There you go.
That's perfect. What, that's what I'm having right now.
Perfect. Why do you got to go get racial on us?
Why you got to do that?
It's my bucket list.
So,
but drinking the Negra over here.
Yeah, I want a Negra.
Last week we were off the air, but Roy was at the Brea Improv, world famous Brea Improv. And how was that, buddy?
It was a lot of fun. Had a cool guest list showed up. I had a lot of people show up, and it was a blast. Pretty full crowd. Comics did a good job. And dude, come on, man, you love that shit. It's just when you get up and you get on. It's just that's what we do. It's just I don't know. Let's everything go away, and we just fired up. Everyone's toasting right now. Jimmy's doing the pick through the window. There we go. I should have brought my chaotic cup.
Nice.
This is coffee I'm drinking. Bullshit.
Is this coffee? It looks civilized.
This is Southern sweet tea I'm drinking right here.
Pink, is it? Pinkies up, boys.
Wow.
As far as we know.
In a tall silver can.
Hey, I'm telling you right now, though. I mean, Ernie's going to like whoop our ass here because he's working out like a fiend. Like
yeah, he is.
Oh, my gosh.
He's killing it.
I'm telling you. I go to this gym in Redlands. And I'm over here thinking, it's like, God, they're going to whip my ass. But this is a fat guy-friendly gym.
Nice. I like
it. So I really love it. They let you work at your own pace. But in a way, some of the trainers will have you do stuff. And I will just say to myself, like, oh, forget this. They'd be like, now stick your legs 90 degrees in the air. And I'm just like, oh, bullshit. How about 9 inches off the ground? How about that?
How about that'll work? It's a 90 degree something.
So they got you playing Twister.
Pretty much. You know?
Hey, when they say a fat friendly gym, what does that mean? Like they have a sushi bar by the weights?
You know what? No, they don't have a sushi bar, but what's crazy is they have a beer brewery right across the parking lot.
Oh, beautiful. Damn.
Where's this at?
This is in Redlands. And also, too, there's a Bravo Burger around the corner. So when they tell you to go do your jog to the end of the building, I'm just like, oh, I'm going to take off because I smell Bravo Burger that way.
Right.
So I'm going to float that way. But, you know, I'm doing pretty good, though. And I've already done it a month straight. And I'm about to do a 6-week 20-pound weight loss challenge this coming Monday.
Good for you, man. Congrats. It's a lot of hard work. Good for you.
It is. And a lot of people say, they go, we can really see it in your face.
I love that when they say your face. Well, what about my ass?
Well, that's what I'm saying. I go, why can't it work its way up? Well, from waist up. I don't want, you know, the little weenus area if my mom is listening.
You're familiar with Roy's bit. You know, for every pound you lose, you gain an inch.
Yeah, every 20 pounds you lose, it's an inch, brother.
Ah, well, then okay.
I went from what you need to an Audi. It worked. I did. Oh, we got one here. Line one, you're on the air.
What, am I on the air now?
Oh, Jesus Christ. You got to come down with Slappy.
Yes. Hello.
Am I on the air?
Yes, you're on the air, John.
You are on the air, John. How are you, buddy?
Hola, mijo, senor fija, and all that good stuff. I'm Hispanic tonight.
Yes, well, that's our buddy. It's our buddy John Kevari on the phone. Thank you, buddy, for calling. And how have you been?
I've been okay. Yeah.
Just okay, yeah, not better than okay. Come on, John. You're usually better than okay.
Well, I haven't been doing comedy. I made a big mistake. I took a comedy class.
Yeah.
And that really screwed me up.
Yeah. I like when they do that, right?
Yeah.
I did that too. I took a stage confidence class. You know, it messed my head up. It was hard to perform for like 3 weeks.
I know.
It's like,
so congratulations on 1 year.
Thank you, John.
And thanks for being a part of it more than once.
Absolutely.
I'm very happy. And by the way, Steve Cooper, he calls up and he does Jerry Lewis. He doesn't know how to do it. I know how to do it, okay?
Well, let's hear it.
Lady! That's how you do it.
That's how you do it. So if Steve calls, he's going to have a hard time keeping up with you, right?
Nobody does not know how to do it.
Lady!
Lady!
Lady! Hello, lady! I feel like we should be doing Pee Wee's Playhouse. When everyone says lady, everyone goes crazy.
Yeah, exactly.
Oh, man.
Wow.
So what are you guys going to do tonight? Are you guys going to give away anything? Or?
Yeah, actually, we have a clown in the front office we're going to give away.
Oh, okay.
Yeah,
we'll give him away. He's gonna like He's got a horn. He's been honking, so he's going to be honking some horns. You know what I mean? Guys, you know what I'm saying?
You guys have no idea what I went through.
I know.
I was honking my horn last night.
Oh, were you?
Oh, hold on. I'm not surprised.
I am. I gotta have some amusement in my life.
The funny thing is, I know which hand he was using.
I know. That's crazy.
You gotta go there, huh? You gotta go there. All right. Is that Vasquez?
Yes, that's him.
You gotta go there.
Hey, you know what? We gotta talk to you about something, John.
Right.
Well, it seems that like you used our show to get on one of Vic's shows.
I know, and I had to cancel. I'm sorry.
You went and pulled a Roy on him, is what you did.
A Roy?
Yeah, last time he was...
Roy's canceled that 3 back-to-back, so don't feel bad.
Okay, all right.
But I love you, babe. I love you, John. You crack me up. I'm dying over here just listening.
All right.
I watch this, John. We got line 2 on the air, John.
Who is
that?
Line 2.
Who is it? It's Scott Shimamoto.
Scott! What's up, baby?
Scott!
What's cracking?
Mushy, mushy.
I said I had to call right in.
He said mushy. Mushy, mushy. What the hell was that?
Mushy, mushy. What's up, mushy, Scott? Mushy.
John's like, he's ninja, man. Not ninja. Ninja.
Ninja.
Ninja.
Ninja. Like a chef over there, man. What's going on?
Hey, nothing, Scott. Man.
How are you, Scott?
I'm doing good. I'm congratulating these guys for having a great show for how long?
Been a year now.
We hit a year.
It's a year?
Yeah.
Like 6, 7, 8, 9 years.
6, 7, 8, 9.
It seems like a long time, guys.
Sometimes it seems like a long time. Usually when John calls, it seems like a long time.
And sometimes it feels like we just started.
Yeah, yeah. That happens a lot, too.
Well, how have you been, Scott? What have you been up to, buddy?
Just doing shows. I did that Burbank Comedy Festival.
Yeah, you like that?
Yeah, I got sick too. I accidentally did one of the disgusting things in life.
I guess you guys don't need me anymore, huh? Scott Shimamoto called up and John. Okay.
Sorry, John. Sorry, John. We got a bigger name on the other line.
Second banana now.
Well, you know, the funny part is we tell people like Scott and other people about you, and they're like, oh, John, I haven't seen John forever. So it's kind of like reuniting.
Yeah, we're helping here. We're the conduit.
We're reuniting all right, started at the same time, and we're all kind of reuniting through the show. So it's a beautiful thing.
I haven't seen John for a long time, but what I did that was gross was I accidentally, and you guys know this, I touched my lip to the mic.
Oh,
that is one of the most disgusting things. That's the worst thing you can do. They should have microphone condoms or something.
No, Scott, that's not the worst thing you can do, trust me.
The worst thing you can do is drive.
What's that, John?
I'm just kidding, Scott.
I've been worse.
What's the worst things, John?
No, you know, I was doing one of those nudist comedy shows that who's the comic of what's going on? I forget his name.
Who?
There's a guy locally who does nudist comedy shows. Don't you know that?
I don't think he's in our circle, John. Maybe you have to enlighten us.
I know who it is.
Oh, look, Scott knows exactly who it is.
Yeah.
I don't do his shows in the wintertime, I'll tell you that.
I did see. I did watch your video, Scott, on how to properly use chopsticks like a boss.
Wasn't that instructive?
Very, because every time I think I know, then all fingers are going. So I watched it. I got reintroduced, re-instructed, and so next time on sushi, I got this thing. No, don't move the other one. The other one's a pencil.
Watched it. I'm so proud of you guys.
Hey, Scott, do your thing about the difference between the Chinese people and the Japanese people. I love that.
People need to pay for that. I'm not a...
Exactly.
I don't give them away for free anymore, you
know? Oh, shit.
Oh, wow. Jimmy is on the ball as normal.
Hey, Scott, that's all Jimmy. That's all Jimmy Shaw right there.
Hey, guys, I got to go now. Congratulations. I love you guys. I hope to see you soon.
All right, John. Hey, be well, man. Love you, too. Thanks
love
for calling.
Love you, too, buddy. Thanks for calling. Thanks for coming in, John.
All right, bye-bye.
I think maybe he took offense to we had a bigger name on the other line.
Nah.
I think maybe his prepaid cell phone is running out.
His track phone's running down?
Yeah.
Well, the odd thing is every time you can't tell when John calls because the number's always different. So I don't know if that happens or he steals somebody's phone. I'm not quite sure.
He's in some sex call center somewhere and you just call him in on their dime.
A little like, scary. Call right now for some.
Yeah, he jerks off based on the minutes he has left.
Oh, do we really go there? But hey, but Vic, what? We know which hand it was.
We know right? What. There's only one hand he could do it with.
Jesus.
But it always has the Kleenex or rag in the other hand. It kind of makes sense now, doesn't it?
Yeah. Hey, you know, it's funny if they ever do Nemo on Broadway, we know who they could cast.
Oh shit! We're all going to hell.
So what have you been up to, Scott? What do you got coming up, buddy?
I'm doing a show for the veterans, the VFW in Bell Gardens on Friday, September 18th.
Nice.
Yeah, so we're gonna have I'm gonna headline that.
Wow, look at you.
Of course you are.
Of course.
You know why? Because I put the show together, that's why I'm headlining.
Hey, whatever works, brother.
Well, you just started. Exactly. You just started your open mic.
We're on hiatus right now with the joke gym.
Okay. No, there was a different one. You said you were starting up a room.
Oh, no, you know what? I subbed in at Tribal Cafe.
Okay. That's what it was.
A couple of times. That's a pretty good, fun room, actually.
Yeah.
Yeah, it's just, you know, it's just hard parking, but, you know, if you find parking, it's really fun.
Nice.
And really good smoothies down there at the Tribal Cafe.
Ooh, smoothies.
What city is that in, Scott?
It's in L.A. It's near Filipino Town.
Jimmy should know where that's
at. Are you talking about like on Beverly or something like that?
I think it's Temple.
Temple, that's over by Echo Park.
Yeah, close to Echo Park.
It's easy to tell. You get there and everyone's not very tall, so you're in the right spot.
Yeah, you totally know you're there.
Out there because it's near Filipino Town.
Well, if it's Filipino Town, it's like a nurses' convention.
Yeah. So everyone's wearing scrubs and not very tall.
Yeah, you see people with scrubs and just a pan full of lumpias.
Oh, dude, don't start.
I did.
What's that?
A lumpia.
A lumpia. People call it the Filipino egg roll.
Yes.
It's not.
And then it has that sauce that's with it. Are you kidding me?
That's like my favorite. It's adobo.
Oh, the adobo.
Oh, my God.
Yes. Outstanding. Yeah.
And the best thing I ever had in the Philippines was a puto. You ever had a puto?
I got two putos in here with me right now.
That's the best is the puto. You ever had a puto? You know what a puto is, right?
Just finish your story.
It's a rice cake in the Philippines with butter on it. It's like a delicacy.
It's a delicacy. It's rice. It's a delicacy.
So
it's like a how you say it? It's like
I mean the French go I'm gonna do a snail.
But the way they do it
and everyone it's a delicacy. It's
the
rice.
Way they do it. It's like a Mexican pan dulce. It's like a dessert.
Oh no! Wait a minute! Don't start with pan.
Yeah. So.
Nice.
That stuff's good.
You know what I like to do is people bring all the pawn over. I like to pick all the shit off the top and then leave them naked in there.
Now you sound like Kevari.
I leave the naked bread and I pick up all the dulce off the pawn.
Oh, that's hilarious.
What am I going to do with your buddy over here, Jimmy?
I don't know.
I tell you, he's knowledgeable though, right?
No, he is. I give him that.
Yeah. Knowledgeable.
Yeah. I give you that.
How? Because I know what the freaking big bread is with the shit on the top?
No, because you have a damn computer over here that you start reading everything in 2 seconds.
No, I didn't even touch anything. I'm just right there replying to when people like shit right now because it's our anniversary.
Yep.
And I'm drinking a Coors Light out of a coffee cup. I'm a classy guy.
Pinky's up.
Hey,
Pinky's
Scott, up, how buddy. did that Burbank festival go for you?
It was good. It was really good. There was a lot of industry down there and... a lot of really good comedians. It was fun.
Well, of course, you were there.
Yeah, exactly.
Hey, was Cam Rowe down there? I heard he did the show, too.
Cam Rowe made the best of the best.
Oh, wow.
Did he really?
Wow, yeah. That's awesome.
All right. Look at him.
I always tell him he's too tall to be in the game. 5'7 is the max tallness.
Dude, this is the max tallness.
I did one of Victor's shows at La Luna. And Cam was on it, and we did the group picture. I was behind Cam, and I'm not in the shot.
You look like his date. What are you talking about?
I mean, you barely see my head, but it looked like that scene in Pulp Fiction.
No,
but I was the one with the ball in my the ball gag.
The best one was a couple of weeks ago. He was at my wing pit show. and Cooch was the headliner, right? And we made him stand on the edge of the stage, and then Cooch goes, "Let's all just stare at him." And we, it's a great shot. Rosemary,
it must be a strong stage because we stand on one end. You just really balanced.
You just hear the creaking going on.
Right.
It's coming down.
Now, Victor is blowing up. Victor Vasquez,
right?
Blowing up, dude. I see you everywhere, man.
Oh, dude, I'm trying, man. You know how the game is. You sell, without a manager or PR company, you got to promote yourself.
Yeah, well, man, weren't you opening for Willie Barcena
yeah,
or something?
Yeah, this weekend I opened up for him at the Ice House. Oh,
that's crazy, man.
Dude, you had
Everybody
no idea.
That
three sold-out shows, it was amazing.
That's wow. So freaking cool.
Amazing. And then in the main room, so...
I love the main room there.
Yeah.
So much energy. It was a great night too, because even in stage two, you had Brian McDaniel and DJ Cooch. They had their show in stage two going on, sold out.
Wow.
And then that was on Friday. Then on Saturday, Sebastian Santina had his show.
Wow.
And that thing was sold out. I mean, the Ice House was jumping this week, and it was amazing. Both stages were packed. And, you know, the staff over there, I mean, I'm telling you, I mean, I don't want to kiss ass or anything, but, man, they make you feel like family.
The best. I did a show there. I totally agree. Ever since we started as rookies there, me, Roy, Big Earn, Brandon there is just the best guy there. But we were doing a Bobby show, and I was sick so bad. I mean, I had a cold that was real bad, and it got worse as I got toward the show. Went to the bar, and I said, how you doing? I said, I got a cold. He goes, hang on. So they mixed me this hot toddy of something. He says, drink this halfway through the guy before you. It's all right. So I did. By the time I went on stage, I was feeling excellent. Went up there, blasted it out, had a great time. Next guy after me, after he was done, I was back to being sick. But he said, this will hook you up.
It'll hook you up for your set?
Yeah. He said, you'll be fine. Take it about halfway through before you go up.
You know what's bad is they're looking at you going, okay, how much time you got?
Right.
Because they got to make sure, okay, how much you got on stage? We can't go overdo it.
Right.
They just give you what you need.
Yeah. I remember doing the open mic there when I first started, probably like 7 years ago. And Dave McNary was running it on Saturdays. And he runs a Sunday show in stage two.
Okay.
When it was still called the Annex, but still does that now. And so that Ice House is great. There's nothing like the sound of the crowd in that main room.
Nothing.
Yeah.
Nothing like
it. It actually explodes in your face.
Nothing like. In fact, they tell people don't use that as your audition tape because they already know that it sounds better.
No, the funny thing about the main room is, you know you either sucked or you know you did good.
Right. If you don't hear nothing in that main room, you are in the wrong business if you don't hear that.
Well, you know what's funny is it reminds me of when it explodes in your face. Remember that old JBL commercial where the guy's in the chair?
Right.
Yeah.
And he turns it on. It's like, that's what it reminds me of when it's just on fire that.
And you know, last time I did it, we weren't there for a long time. And then you hear that first laugh hit you and it hits you right in the chest. And you're just like, oh, this is great. I'll just perform here.
But that goes back to what Roy was saying in the beginning of the show when you were asking about the Brea. By the way, I went to his last Brea show, not this one, but the one before that.
That's
He owns that. Roy really owns that place.
That room, yeah.
Yeah. But
thanks, man.
He you know how he says that, you know, this is what we do. We live for this shit. Mm-hmm. Absolutely. When you do the Ice House like that, just.
Someone asked me, it was just this weekend, I think I was talking to Don's family. And I said, I'll have a drink now and then, but I've never been a drug guy or, you know, it's just not me.
Right.
But I can, it's like almost that's what it is. It is a freaking drug. When you're on top of the world like that, I can't imagine anything feeling any better. I mean, it's just like, this is it right here.
Well, Scott, you could vouch, right? When you get off the stage and you just nailed that, you know, right, Ernie, when you nail it?
Yeah.
When you nail it and you get off stage? And you have to come down?
Because, yeah, you can't.
Right? So
because you're shaking. You're like so hype. You're shaking.
Yeah.
And I know. I knew I nailed it.
Check it out.
Yeah.
Seriously. I just showed Vic my arm. It's all the hair standing up on my arm because it's true.
It's true. I nailed it. I mean, just, I mean, bases loaded, bottom of the ninth, just out of the park, the 10 o'clock show, just nailed it. And then I go into the green room and Willie's sitting there. And he sees me pacing, and he looks at me, And I go, hey, sorry. He goes, no, I understand. Keep, you know, do your pacing. He goes, come off it. He goes, I totally get it. Willie goes, I totally get it. And he sat there and watched, you know, he watched the whole thing on the monitor and stuff like that. He goes, you owned that room. That was yours.
That's badass, man. But, badass.
Congratulations.
Oh, thanks, brother. Thanks. But, you know, I think everyone here and hopefully everyone else that calls, everybody understands, we're just all trying.
Yeah. Well, you know, the great part is we're all talking, but we can all pick each other's out favorite sets of ours. You know,
Chinese people.
I know the show I saw where I thought Scott did the best that I've ever seen. I know the one Ernie did where I saw the best one I thought he did. Roy, Victor, all my friends. I can say, you know what? You did good here. But my favorite is when you did that, you know, and that just tells you how close we are, our little community here, you know. It's like, you know, Victor, we did that show in the backyard for Johnny.
Yeah.
One of the loosest, funnest sets I've ever seen you do.
Oh, yeah, yeah.
It was a different Vic I saw, and it was hilarious, you know. Yeah. Big Earn It, one of my favorites I saw you do was the last Ice House show that me, you, and Roy did.
Oh, my God. I love the Ice. I haven't been there in years, but that's where I got my first start, was at the Ice House, and it was a Bobby show. And like he was saying, when you go on stage, you kind of feel a little bit nervous. But when you hear that first laugh, boom, it hit me. And I remember probably about a minute into my set, when I heard that first laughter, I was so into it. I said, you know, to hell with it. I'm just going to have a good time. And as soon as I got off stage, I was battling a cold. And a buddy of mine gave me a flask. He said, here, take a swig of it before I go up. And I was so nervous.
You hear that, Scott? He shared a flask.
Well, hey. I don't know what it was filled with, but it did the job. But as soon as I heard that first laughter, it was so much fun. And going out in the patio and, you know, greeting the people, that even made it even the best.
Yeah, that's one of the few places where they come out and they actually say hi to you and tell you, you know, great dude, set. Of course, they got you trapped there, too, so they can't help it.
Yeah.
Yeah, but the best thing is to sell your merchandise there.
Yeah.
Yeah. You saw my Straight Outta Marriage?
Dude, I did. I love it, man.
Rose set that up. She's doing the coffee mugs.
Oh, nice.
Yeah, and then the t-shirts are coming Straight Out of Marriage.
Nice. Let me know when that's available. I definitely need a cup, buddy.
Yeah, I'll hook you up.
Cool.
Hook us up.
Sounds good. Yeah. We're going to take our first break. Scott, you going to hang on? Are you done for tonight?
Hey, if you want me to hang on, I'll hang on.
It's totally up to you, buddy.
You know I love being on your show.
Hang on.
We're going to get you back in studio again, too. So,
Ashley, all right. Roy, take us out, buddy.
I'll take you out.
Real quick, when we come back, though, we got a special guest. We have to take care of some business.
Yeah, some business coming our way.
Some business to be taken care of.
I brought the Benadryl.
There you go. Then we're all set for that.
Right on. You're listening to Roy and Jimmy Thing on kaoticradio.com. This is our 1 year, baby. We'll see you back in a minute. Welcome back to the Roy and Jimmy Thing here on kaoticradio.com.
We had to come back into our Art LeBeau theme with Victor.
Yeah. Every time Vic's in, we get into Art LeBeau. Welcome back, man. Anniversary special. We got some business to take care of.
We got Scott Shimamoto still on the phone.
Yeah, let me take Scott off hold because he's got to have some fun with it. Let's see. Here we go. No, wait. There is a button. So we got Scott. Scott, you still with us?
I'm still here.
I can't believe you waited through a break just sitting on the whole listening to this shit.
What are you talking about? He posted like 20 things.
I saw.
He's a busy man. On the phone, Scott Shimamoto, and in studio, Ernie Avila. Sorry, I am your damn Coors Light. Victor Vasquez, Roy Brewster, myself, Jimmy Shaw, and our buddy from the Caddock Locker Room, Matt Alldredge.
Hello.
We have a little business to take care of. I don't know. As most of you know, I think it was 2 months ago, we have a Giants-Dodgers rivalry. So we did a bet, and the loser had to win, wear the other person's jersey. So I donned the Giants jersey, weak profile pick. And unfortunately for him, we swept this last week. And he's a gentleman. He's manning up. That was the bet. So he'll be putting on my Dodger jersey. And I know this is killing him.
It is.
It's going to kill him, but the hashtag man up.
I am. I am a man of his word. I'm a man of my word.
He's a man of his word.
I'm happy for your guys' anniversary, but I'm not very happy to be here.
today.
No.
My favorite part of that is what I saw says, like, that's just, you're going to put the profile picture up and you will be doing Instagram and Twitter.
As soon as a picture goes live onto Facebook, I am shutting down my Facebook for the week. I'll just be on Instagram and Twitter this week. So I'm just ashamed of myself for even making a bet that would result to this.
Yeah, I conceded. I think we had a 2 out of 3, and I conceded halfway through the second game. I went, okay, just pick the jersey. It's going to happen.
Yeah, no, the Giants are they're killing me right now.
Well, friends are going to understand because mine know how much I'm a diehard Dodger fan. And as soon as they saw the picture, they said, oh, lost a bet?
Yeah, exactly. Oh, everybody knows. Yeah, I pre-warned everybody.
There you go. Tell Diana, I'm sorry. I know it's killing her too.
I know. I told my kids, they asked why I was coming here today, and they were all excited. They're like, oh, you got to give us the picture so they can put it on their iPads, their home saver. Yeah, it's not good.
I thought you were going to say they're home crying right now. There's no Santa Claus. Daddy's wearing a Dodger shirt.
Yeah, that's true. That's a possibility.
Hey, Jimmy, did you set it up? They're out there wrapping his car right now too, right?
Yeah, exactly. Oh, great. Yeah, Blaine's had the vinyl cut going on.
Right. It could have been worse. The bet that myself and Ryan had back when we had our show, he had to put a sticker on his.
That's right.
He had to rock a sticker on his car for a week.
Back window, full size.
Yeah, huge sticker that Blaine put on when the Giants beat the Angels. That would have been worse. So the shirt I can deal with, like I said, I'll be suspending my Facebook for 7 days.
I could see if that would happen to you. I could see just like we're parking the car and renting one for a week.
Absolutely. Yeah. I'd have called in sick for a week. Yeah, I wouldn't have gone anywhere.
I
rode my bike. So
that's all right.
Yeah. So I guess it's time.
It's go time.
All right. Well, Jimmy's got the jersey here.
Not only the jersey, the damn music's still in the background.
He's trying to ease the pain for you a little bit.
Just trying to keep it soothing.
You're going to need to do that.
All right, Roy, you got the camera ready?
No, I'm not just doing a camera. I got to do the video.
Hey, did you want a beer? Did you want a beer before this?
No. Okay. Yeah, be a real Dodger. Hold a beer in hand.
Yeah, be a real Dodger. Have a beer and hit somebody on the way out.
Hey, he's a Giants fan. He's going to kick his own ass out in the parking lot.
All right, here we go. Oh, Jesus. It's going live right now. Here it is. I got Jimmy in the background. I might have to get skinny for this shirt. I don't know if you had to get skinny or not, but here. Oh, dude, you're getting a rash.
It's already happening.
This is the worst thing ever.
Hey, it fits you good.
Well, a lot of things fit me good, and you look like this.
It's
he looks like a Dodger fan from the IE.
Riverside, somewhere around there.
Man, look at it. This is going all over Facebook. You know that, right?
Here comes Boss Man right here.
This is
Blaine's got to take the picture.
Blaine's gonna get the picture.
Yeah,
looks like a prison jumpsuit.
All right, well,
I had to get there. It is.
Skinny, I think.
Hey, since Scott's on the phone, can we order takeout?
All right, you taking the picture, Roy?
No, I was doing video. Now I'm going to do a picture because Jimmy wants a picture too. Hold on, man.
I don't want a picture too. That's the we need the picture.
No, we'll get
you
a picture.
Better come get it. I'm not keeping this thing
on. No, hurry up. Hold on. I feel his pain. Hurry up.
There it is.
All right.
Now, how long do you have to leave it on? You can take it off now, right?
I'll take it off right now. I did the same thing. Immediately off, we're good.
Oh, that's all you had to do?
That was it. No, he's got to post his picture.
Now it's a profile.
His profile
for
a
week.
He just took it off and threw it.
That is some mild irritation right there.
Hey, you're lucky he didn't just wipe his ass with it.
No shit, right?
I should give it to Slappy out there.
Slappy just slapped up on a little bit. Yeah, well, we should have had Slappy in here with you.
No, we shouldn't have.
No, we're good enough.
Now there'd be piss stains on that jersey.
Hey, Scott, you still having fun?
I am listening. I'm trying to find all these pictures. Are they going up or what?
Oh, they'll be up quick.
Yeah.
Yeah, they'll be up very soon, I'm sure.
Very soon.
I'm going to post a video right now.
The sooner they're up, the sooner they're off. That's how we worked it out.
Yep. So, yes.
So what time do they get to come off?
Whatever time I change it. So as soon as I see it, I'm changing my profile picture to it and then shutting down my Facebook. So hopefully roughly 9:45 next Tuesday.
About 9:45.
Yeah.
You're not even going to give us to the 10 minutes, no?
No,
we went to the minute because Brandon Barber lost a bet that same show, and he wanted to do it early and said, no, it was 7:41, buddy.
He was going to take it off at like midnight, 12:01.
Right, he was going for the day.
Go back to the timestamp.
Yeah, so I ordered the same thing. I think mine was at 7:44 on my evening of out, and I said, we'll go right to the time. We said 1 week.
Yeah, they're hardcore.
I know.
All right, well, it's rough. Thanks for doing that. Sorry you had to do it, but you manned up.
Can somebody send the picture? Blaine, do it. Anybody?
I've got one. I thought Blaine had one. Blaine had a good one.
Well, send it to me or do something. Need to get this thing started.
Well, I don't want to put mine up until the other one goes up, because otherwise I'll start the clock early.
Okay, it's up.
It's up.
Blaine Hubble's page.
Jesus.
Damn,
great radio.
I got to say,
man. It's great radio right now.
We're all searching our phones. Yeah. Right.
And what's hilarious is his kids are at home waiting.
I got to.
I know.
They're all waiting to see Pops.
I got to say, Matt, you're a good-looking dude in this picture.
Boy, I'm happy. Dodger jersey has never looked so good.
Oh, that's a great shot.
That's a great picture.
Did you see it, Scott?
I'm looking at it. You say, what, me?
Yeah, that's exactly it.
Unbelievable. Right?
It's over. It starts it now. Is. Now he's just
no. He's
Facebook
doing it. He's doing
off.
It right now. He's set it profile. Now he's going to crop it.
Yeah.
And there it is.
Jeez.
Yeah. Victor's witnessing it.
Oh, dude, this is.
He's awesome. Walking. Vic's looking over his shoulder, going, "Oh,
hey,
nice."
And I'm a Dodger fan, so this is cool.
That's so funny. You know how he's wearing his hat on backwards?
Yeah.
You know, I never wear my hat backwards like that because when I do, I look like I'm getting ready to build a railroad.
Shit.
I wish I could rock a baseball cap on that. When I was rapping, I couldn't do it. I had to put it forward.
Wow. So I look like I'm ready to build a railroad?
No, you're not Asian enough to be building a railroad.
Scott, dude, I threw off my headphones. I lost it, Scott.
Oh, shit.
Jesus Christ.
All right, there it is. It's been profile picture updated. That's so
good. Oh,
guys, let's see it. Let me see it. Oh,
Jesus, God.
That was freaking hilarious. Oh, there it is.
Oh.
Yeah, I see it. Not Giants, Dodgers, MLB, Jimmy. Ooh, well, there it is.
That is so funny. It's like to be a Giant, I'll tell you.
Diana's already on there. My poor husband.
My poor husband.
No, we'll just follow. This is terrible. We'll follow the comments while we're still on.
Well, I think that the pain that you felt and I felt this year with these bet loss, I threw it out there for Ryan, the CFO, because we're playing the Angels right now.
Right.
And he didn't even jump in on this one.
He wanted no part of it?
Yeah. He said, what's going to happen when I lose is what his opener was.
Right.
So
he had a lot of confidence in his team there.
Yeah,
guess,
he's pretty well done with that. So
if you had a 6L jersey, I would have took you up on the bet, but
yeah.
I don't want to rip it in half. I don't want to do it like a fat guy in a little coat kind of thing.
The Farley thing.
Yeah.
It's hey, I got a Dodger car cover.
Oh shit.
That's close enough.
Damn.
Stick his arm out where the wheel holes go.
Well, damn. Hey, well, Scott went straight out hop sync on us.
Yes, he did.
With that comment, I lost it.
Hop sync.
Oh, my God, Scott. That was
awesome. We were trying to order Chinese takeout, and you guys can't tell the difference between Chinese and Japanese anyway.
No, you're right. You're right.
We do all look alike. I got to say that.
The only time I could tell the difference is when you guys do the laundry.
Not so much starch, damn it. Oh, tell your family.
The ancient Chinese secret.
Oh my God, Scott, you cracked me up. That was good.
So funny.
I love Scott.
Thank you. He's here all week.
Yeah, he's here all week long.
Scott cracks me up, man. I love him.
Isn't it fun to do comedy, guys? It's so fun. I just love it.
It is.
Oh.
And real estate. You've got a little one bedroom condo available.
I do. I'm ready. My tenant is moving out. She's been there for like 4 or 5 years, and she was always right on time with the rent.
MSL number 3453 MK3.
I saw the post today. It looks like a really great. It's a great price for the area.
Hey, let me tell you about Scott. Scott, marketing when it comes to being a comic, and marketing when it comes to real estate, he's badass. He got it down. Look at all the postings.
If I could just get to that level with my comedy, I could be a star. I want to be like Fluffy. Fluffy is such a great marketer.
Oh yeah, funny, for sure.
He's funny, you know. He's obviously funny, but he knows how to market himself.
Oh my, my boy is tired. He's hanging it up. he's like done.
Gotta go to bed.
All right, Matt. Thanks for coming in, buddy.
Hey, guys. Congratulations on your 1 year anniversary. Yeah. That's excellent.
You know, thanks for coming in, man.
No problem. Yeah, 1 year, that's a long time. I think Ryan and I did our show for, I think, 9 months. But I think of that 9 months, we were on vacation for three of them. So it's a lot more work than you think. So
how bad do you miss it, though?
I miss being in the studio here.
Right.
I don't miss preparing for the show. Yeah. And I don't miss missing my son's
sports
games or my daughter's sporting event. So
yeah, I don't know how Blaine does it every day.
I don't either.
Three hours.
It definitely makes you respect.
Yeah.
I stress for over 2 hours for 1 day a week. 2 hours a week, you'd stress for like 3 days trying to plan your whole schedule and plan your whole days. And so, no, I like I said, I miss doing the show, actually being here doing it, but I don't miss everything else. So
no.
But thank you guys for letting me come on in. And,
thanks for coming in, buddy.
Yeah, no problem. You guys have a good show.
Okay, man.
See ya.
Thanks, Matt. Drug him out.
That's a trooper right there.
Yeah. A trooper. Man, look at him. He's like can't get out of here any faster. He's like he's going to kick the jersey on the way out. Oh, look, he's going to hang it up. What a nice guy. You know why? That's respect.
Yeah.
He's hanging it back on the hanging it back up. He's hanging it. You know, when Jimmy, when you wore his, you actually color coordinated the undershirt.
Are you guys ready for your gifts?
Oh shit.
Oh.
You got gifts?
I don't know. We do it now, or we should take a break and get some gifts?
It's up to you.
I don't know. What do you think, Jimmy? Do it after next break. So he's walking around.
A little bit longer.
Make who wait?
The guy who wants to give you gifts.
Oh shit! Why am I thinking I don't even want them?
Yeah, we got about.
Well, you want them.
We got about 7 minutes till the next break, so we'll do it then.
Yeah, we'll do it after the break.
We'll do it then.
Yeah. Damn it. Hey. Scary as shit, dude. Oh, I don't even know.
You
what's
guys
going
have
on.
No idea what's coming, but. We could see him sitting outside in the lobby.
Yeah.
Yeah, no, we saw him before the show.
Anyway, big shout out to Matt for coming in. That was awesome.
Yeah, that was cool.
And manned up. We both have the man up. And for a Giants-Dodgers rivalry, the man up, that's something.
Hey, can I give a quick shout out to some people that are listening right now?
Yeah, absolutely.
Anything, okay. Buddy.
Patty Vega's out there. She's listening. She posted on Facebook that she's listening. My godson Michael's up over there. I don't know where he's at. Chatsworth probably today listening. Also, my cousin Janice is up in the Hesperia listening, and thank you guys for the support. I got, you know Richard Barber, right?
Yeah,
yeah, he's listening, so that's pretty cool. I got Andrea Felix and Richard Hugo, my boy Hugo and Rose are out there.
Hugo,
and then Lisa and Fonseca's out there with Pete. Daphne, thank you so much for listening. Hey, my ex-wife's cousin, Robert.
Yeah.
He's out here in Fontucky. He's listening, so that's
cool.
Oh,
nice. Appreciate
it. So thank you, guys.
It.
Thank you so much for supporting 1 year anniversary. Roy and Jimmy.
Roy and Jimmy thing, yeah. Yeah. We started out as the Roy Brewster experiment.
Yeah,
and,
that wasn't that great, wasn't it?
And, we worked our way through, and since we started having guests and then you guys supporting us, we couldn't be here without the obviously Blaine in the station and everyone here. But you guys coming out and supporting us and having a great time with us, it's just been the best.
Now, Droopy's listening. Flacco.
Yeah. There we go. Fun. That's what we wanted to hear.
Yes.
You know what my favorite thing is? Poor Scott still listened to this shit.
I know. Because I was going to start dedicating to Ching Pong Hao. Don't mean hell. Only nobody gets you down.
Oh, shit.
He's like, shout out to combo number 9.
Wow.
You order fly lice, you eat fly lice.
I freaking love Scott.
You know why I love Chinese food? Okay, you guys know this. When I'm eating Japanese food, I need to eat it with Japanese rice that sticks together.
Right.
And then when I'm eating Chinese food, I need to eat it with that Chinese rice that falls apart. That's weird. Isn't that weird?
Whoa. I'm trying to put... What?
No, he's right. He's absolutely right.
You have to eat Chinese rice with Chinese food and Japanese rice with Japanese food. It's really weird.
No, there's a difference with the content of the rice sticks.
Well, hold a minute.
Right?
You're telling me the difference in rice. Like, I don't know. I eat this shit all the time. But I never thought it'd break it down to like, dude, I'll throw all that shit on a plate. I don't care where it came from.
I'm memorized just hearing him.
No, like, Scott, you know why? You're right. My stepson, my oldest, he's a Japanese and Mexican. Filipino. German. No, he's German, Japanese, Mexican. He's like a ninja Nazi cholo, dude.
Wow. Wow.
Yeah. No, but the thing is, he was a sushi chef. And my daughter asked, they worked that same, but you know, the condensity of the way the Japanese rice is made, you're absolutely right. I know exactly what you're talking about.
The condensity of the weight.
The way it sticks together.
The shit he knows. Filipino food.
The consistency.
Filipino that food. Too. Rice consistency.
Dude, I'm 5 beers in. Leave me alone.
He was getting all technical. The condensity of the matter, of the weight, of the rice, of the kernel. And you ever see when you go to, they can carve your name in the rice? Never mind.
Hey, all of a sudden, Roy is Mr. fucking Rogers over here.
Got it, right?
Yeah, I like that. I'm Ernie, Mr. help fucking me out Rogers. Over here.
You know what I'm talking about, right?
Yes, I do.
Get another Coors Light.
So I like the Japanese rice. Because it's easier to eat with chopsticks, because you can just smash it to the side and you right. scoop it up. Exactly. It's easier
right.
to eat,
exactly.
right?
You know, so, I'm ashamed to
what
say
what
this.
What the Japanese people have done is we've taken all the Chinese inventions and we take them, right? We perfect them and then we claim them. Okay, for instance, rice. The Chinese rice falls apart, right?
Yeah, what the hell?
Right? And then so what we did, we got the rice so it'll stick together and that way you can make sushi with it.
Right?
See? Rice. You know, it's all Japanese rice sticks together, so you can make a little rice ball, put a little fish on top. I can do that with Chinese rice.
I can do that with Chinese rice.
No, you're right.
Okay. Well, we got line one telling us about rice now. Line one, what kind of rice do you like?
What kind of rice do I like?
Yeah.
I'm just barely kidding. I have no clue what you're talking about.
What's up, man? How you been?
Good, guys. How are you?
We're doing well. Not good thing you didn't make a bet.
I am so glad I didn't make a bet. If you did one, I would honor it, but I knew it would be bad. I'm just leaving the game right now early. I never leave games early.
It's 6-2, right?
Now. The Angels and the Dodgers pitch.
Is it still 6-2? What is it?
It's over now. It's pretty much over.
I don't think it's over. I think it's still the top of the – it's only top of the ninth right now.
Yeah, I was there last night. It wasn't very pretty either.
Wait, only the top of the ninth?
Well, so
I'm on the freeway home. I've never do this. It's that bad.
Well, so you know, this is CFO. It's Ryan.
Oh, okay.
Ryan's on the phone with us.
All right.
Who's saying oh like that? They're pleasantly surprised.
No, they're in awe because of who they're speaking to right now.
It's Victor. That's why.
It's Victor. He's 5 beers in. Don't pay attention,
Mr. Victor.
15 in.
You're 15 in. Attaboy.
There with you guys, and I can't believe I sacrificed going to your 1-year anniversary show to go to this game to see your stupid Dodgers beat the shit out of my. Congratulations on 1 year. You guys are the energy, you're the smiles, you're the humor, you're everything that keeps chaotic going, and I love you guys. I love hearing. I may tune in minutes here and there, and I can't tune in all the time because I'm Mr. Dad all the time, but I congratulate you guys. I love you both dearly, and I love what you do for the station. I love your show, and I can tune any time or tune into your podcast or whatever. It's what keeps the station going, and you're what we're about, and I congratulate you. Thank you for everything you guys do, and props to a fun year, and hope to many, many more, but thanks for all you guys do. I love you both.
Yeah, love you back, man. Thank you. I mean,
so appreciate that, Ryan.
Yeah, we know that we are very lucky to be part of this station, and we make no bones about it because not many people put idiots like us on the air. So we're all in, man.
You guys are great. I still have not seen either one of you in stand up, and I'll admit it. The only reason I don't go, it's like if you know a guy who's like a fighter, an MMA fighter, you can't watch him fight because you're like nervous for him.
Right.
I'm like nervous as much as I know you're both funny MFers.
You don't want to see the bad night.
Right.
I can't go see you live, but I want to go. I will. I'll do it. Once I get more confidence in both of you.
Oh, wow. After he built us up, he just kicked us in the balls.
Ouch.
That's actually fair enough.
I want to go see you guys so bad. You're
fair enough.
Funniest freaking guys ever. Love you,
bro. Oh, shit. That was classic. Hey, man, Ryan, love you back, brother. That's very cool.
I was like, man, that was so effing sincere and from the heart. And everything. I was like, listen, the whole buildup, and all of a sudden, well, but I just don't know if you guys are going to suck if I end up going to the show.
I'm not surprised because this white guy is
about to witness the strength. It's straight
hardcore NWA. This is Ryan Combe right here.
Love this stuff. Right here, dude.
That is Ryan. Ryan doesn't know it, but people wouldn't guess it, but that's Ryan right there.
I'm gangster.
That's it.
I'm gangster.
Trip for life, for blood. Maybe I'm a blood. I don't know.
I don't know which one. I'm somebody. Wow. Awesome.
That was classic.
I'm glad I can bring some street education to you guys.
Some street cred. Up in this hizzy.
That's my favorite. Where do we go to get street cred? A six foot white dude.
No, you do comedy in Highland Park. You get
street cred. That's where I get my street cred. Street cred.
Oh, that was classic.
Oh,
dude,
shit.
He built you up so nice, and all of a sudden.
No, it was all sincere. It was sincere for the and it was sincere at the end. You guys might suck, and I don't want to see it.
He's a player. That's why. He's a player. He's got this. This is shit right here.
You know why? Because when you're street like that, you just don't care.
You don't care.
Victor Ernie, he went to the premiere of Straight Outta Compton, and he's got a bunch of pictures with everybody.
Like
everybody.
Everybody.
Dr. Dre, Yellow Man, all of them?
Yellow Man's like a reggae guy.
Yeah. Yellow. Excuse me. Look at the white man is correcting.
He just
yellow.
Corrected your
see?
Ass. Yeah.
See what we just said? We weren't kidding.
Straight out of Cucamonga.
I took pictures that everybody was shook.
Yeah, that's because that's all right. Shook still locked up. He'll run you over at a donut shop.
Tupac was there. Biggie, Shook was not.
Here's my favorite part of that. If I was there, they'd be like, "Who's that?" I don't know. That dude over there. He was probably important.
The cool thing
is, an athlete? No.
No, but if you went there,
one, he's a rapper.
No. If Roy went there, everybody would think you're like an agent or a PR guy. They'll be all over you.
Shit.
That must be their accountant over there.
The accountant's over there in the corner.
Yeah, he comes in all stealth. He's like the sleeper cell there.
He must be Hebrew.
whereas Scott is straight ass Asian. He'll let you know. He doesn't even hide it.
Hey, did Alldredge take his picture in a Dodger jersey?
Yep, yeah. He's already posted.
It's posted.
Oh man, I can't wait to see it.
Hilarious.
So glad I didn't bet.
Yeah.
Yeah, we were asking about it. Yeah, he's already on it. It's already posted. I even put a video up.
All right. Well, I will definitely check it all out. But hey, thanks for having me, guys. Have me on, guys. I've had a few beers.
Excellent. Best time to call.
Yeah, best time.
I wish I could have been in there with you guys. If you stay on the air for another hour, I'll be there.
Oh wow, I don't know. We're pretty close to that.
We're here till 11.
Another hour?
Well, we go till 11.
You do?
Yeah, we're not.
I like that he knows everything about us. You go to 11? No shit.
I think guys are 8 to 10.
No, man, 9 to 11.
We're 9 to 11 now.
Oh, I might make it.
All right.
Oh, well, we're here. I got a Corona for you.
All right. Save you one.
Hey, man. Thanks, Ryan.
All right, guys.
All right, man. Thanks, love buddy. You, man.
That was cool.
Yeah, CFO. Colin, take good stuff. The definition
is jacking. He is hardcore.
Hardcore. Scott, give us something hardcore.
Put on his rap song. Remember his rap song?
Yeah, you should put my rap song on.
Oh, bring it up.
Why would I have that ready to go?
There it is.
There it is. Ernie, have you seen this?
No.
You got to go on YouTube.
Yeah.
Scott was a rapper.
Check out my hair.
You got to see his hair, dude. Yeah. He had a pompadour.
He did. That's no bullshit. That's really him, dude. There it is. Right behind you.
hey, Scott, you just dropped the N-bomb on this, didn't you?
No.
Yeah, you did.
Maybe.
Maybe.
Well, because I can't say the R, so maybe I did. I don't know.
You can't say the R.
Don't I look like a more feminine version of Yoko Ono?
Pretty much.
Or like what I say, like, if you're a country and western music fan, I look more like K.D. Lang. Don't look like K.D. Lang. I just like that crazy broad, man.
Jesus. Dude, who Who outed him that I looked that up right away?
Oh, you said it. I looked it up right away as soon as you said that's what he did. Yeah, but I'm like, I got to find it.
Who outed him?
Oh, no, it was...
I posted him.
No, it was... You posted him before, but outed on the show was... Marlon.
That's right, yeah.
Marlon.
Marlon outed you.
Yeah.
This thing's been up for years, and I never saw it.
I can't believe it, but we know it's there now. It's our go-to now.
Marlon was even talking about the whole Bakersfield situation, and he just threw every dirt out there. It was classic.
Nice stuff.
Marlon's a funny guy, man. That guy. He looks like an imam, right?
isn't he the one that always has like that spray can of
liquid ass?
Yeah, liquid ass.
And he has it like in a trunk, and then he sprays it like in people's like parties or something. That's what it smells like.
Just
ass?
Because
elevators, shit yeah, like that. Yeah. Does.
Oh my god, he's a nut.
Take us out, Jimmy.
All right, we're gonna take our second break of the night. We'll come back. We got Scott on the phone. We got Big Earn. We've got Victor. We got me, you, and then we have
check it out. We've had Frank. We've had Kevari. Scott's already here. Ryan was here. We had Matt in studio. And we got more coming.
Yeah, I think we have gifts.
We have gifts coming.
After the next break. So.
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah, oh God.
Oh God.
I'm gonna need a refill on the beer.
Yeah, put that on the
all right.
Video.
Right on.
Wait till you see this.
Do your magic, Jimmy. Get us out of here.
Brace yourself. Smoke if you got them.
Smoke them if you got them. You're listening to the Roy and Jimmy Thing anniversary special on chaoticradio.com. We'll see you in a minute.
He looks like he's working on the... Yes. Cowboy, make me go all out. Up in here.
Welcome back to the Roy and Jimmy Thing here on chaoticradio.com. Anniversary special, whatever the hell that means. Here we are, man, just having a good time.
The second hour.
Hour number two. Oh, shit.
Now, if you're a listener of the station, especially the Blaine Humble Show and various other ones he does drop in, we have in studio now a local comic clown madman, Dan Rupp, is in studio for our anniversary show. And
you might remember Dan from singing I Can't Drive 55 on our show.
And nailing it, crushing it.
Oh, yeah.
Just crushed it. Hi, Dan. Thanks for coming in, buddy.
Thanks, brother.
And we got a picture of this, don't we?
No, I didn't get a picture yet. I was going to get a picture of him walking in, but he just came in already.
Yeah.
Blaine has plenty of pictures.
Okay. He'll share the best one with me. We'll put that up.
No, I'm gonna do one right now because it makes great radio for me to take pictures.
Really?
We're on the air. And it's always best.
And I'll have to say, Victor and Ernie have never looked so good. Oh,
well, I wonder if I can get all three of them.
It's like a handsome sandwich in right there. Yeah, you can.
Yeah, it's like an Oreo cookie.
Wait, hold on. I can get Jimmy in the background, too. There he is.
There you go. That was radio picture right there.
That was radio gold right there. You know, I should have put in selfie mode. I could have got us all.
That's true. Well, we've heard rumors that you have gifts for us.
Yeah, it's an anniversary party. So it's a party without a clown and gifts.
Yeah, exactly.
Without Slappy.
Yeah.
And I really just...
I feel molestation coming on.
It's coming, and you're closest. So you're wondering why I'm on this side of the table, right?
Real quick, though, I do have to plug something here besides... Wait,
please.
Yeah, plug me.
Yeah, plug you guys. Plug yours, guys. We actually have the official Roy and Jimmy thing shirts are available to order online now.
Nice.
Go to our Facebook fan page, Roy and Jimmy Thing. And order up your shirts. We have lady shirts, we have men's shirts, and it's the official Roy and Jimmy shirt available online. Place your orders
for our anniversary shirt.
Oh, yeah. The anniversary shirt. I was gonna say, is it that one?
No, it's a new one. You haven't seen it, it just went up today.
Yeah, it's an anniversary special, and it's gonna be up for a couple weeks and stuff. Limited time run, but big fan, support us, the station. We have our shirts up there, so go to our Facebook page, my page, Roy's page. And tell your friends and help support us in the station.
Share it with your friends, and we're not pulling bones about it. Get on there, get a damn shirt. You're supporting us and making this all happen.
Okay, hold on.
I'm not above begging for you to buy a damn shirt.
Hold on. Mi gente, todos ahí compren una camisa de Jimmy y Roy. Lo están vendiendo on the internet.
Nice. And don't.
Hey, Scott, do your part now.
And don't post it on Twitter because they don't do
that. Give them the phone number. Give them the phone number, Victor.
And if you want to call it.
Well, I'll do Scott's.
Oh, my God. We're
we
all
guys
going
know
to hell.
That your friend Ariana
she posted
your anniversary shirt, and it's on her page right now since 2 hours ago. So an hour before your show even started, she's been advertising for you guys.
Absolutely.
Damn, that's what our people do.
It's so cool.
There's a secret to that. I won't tell you what it is, but there's a secret to that. Tell him, Jimmy.
It's called Big Jimmy, you know what I mean? You know what I'm saying here?
Tell him, Jimmy, why she's doing that. Tell him, Jimmy.
She actually helped set up that whole the t-shirt setup and everything. Just
really?
Yeah, genius. She came up with this whole thing, and it's going to work out great and stuff. So she's the brains behind the operation, man.
Oh, wow.
Yeah, I got one of those too.
Yeah.
And you know it's true.
She said, "What's your shirt plan sale?" I said, "I don't know. I'll go to the swap meet or something." And she goes, "No. We're welcome to the millennium here."
I got one of those twos, but she kicks my ass.
I ain't saying there ain't no bruises.
Yeah, just to don't show.
That's it.
Nice.
You guys need house hospital gowns with your names on it.
No, I see yours right now. It's a little scary.
Wait. Yours is your name and urine, and what else is on it? What did he say was on it? Urine?
If there was a CSI blue light in here, we'd all run.
It would glow.
Wow. We would all run.
Scott, I need your help over here, brother. You got to see what's on
Roy,
over here.
When Roy posts the picture, Scott will know what we're dealing with.
Yeah,
Those guys are pretty big. I don't think I can help you because I don't know kung fu or anything like that.
You don't know anything of that shit.
The only thing I know is run, fool.
Run, fool. Oh shit. We got another call coming in. Line one, you're on the air.
Hey, Roy.
Hey, Dennis. What's up, baby?
Not much. I had to call and tell you guys congratulations.
Well, thank you.
I already ordered my shirt.
Wow. Thanks,
you're the
buddy.
Man.
I will add it to my BOFA shirt, and that'll be the only other thing I wear.
Nice. Thank you, buddy.
That's awesome, dude. Appreciate it.
Every guest we've had in here, as soon as he calls, they said, Dennis, how you doing? Everyone knows Dennis is like comedy's biggest fan, and everybody loves you, man.
Yeah. I won't keep you guys. I got to get my shift started, but letting you know I got everything, got my shirt, and I'm listening on the app on my phone while I walk.
The kaoticradio.com app. See, what did I tell you guys?
And how easy is that to
top use? Of the show. Easy to use. Android, easy. iTunes, iPod, easy. iPad. Ready.
The
You're
app,
good to go.
The app rocks. It's yes. way to go.
All right,
go,
guys.
Man.
Rock on for another year. I'll talk to you later.
All right on, thanks, man. Dennis. Thanks, Dennis. Man. Love you, man.
Bye. Hey, you know the cool thing that you guys are on iTunes? My daughter downloads that and she like shares it with all her friends because she's like a sophomore in high school.
Yeah.
And they're like, man, your dad's a nut. He has cool friends.
Got some cool points for the cool friends.
Yeah. My son's embarrassed in anything I do in here. It's
That's hard to believe.
Wait, hold on. No. Hold on. Wait. Back up. You have a son.
Yeah.
Yeah. I'm like, yeah.
Guys, you got to see the picture.
I just put it up.
You got to see this picture.
You're all tagged. I had to put it up, man.
Oh God!
Shit.
Yeah, so no CSI blue light around that gown.
Oh,
it's been an eventful night, and it's not over yet. You know what I'm saying?
Well, he walked in, and we had the people all here are trying to guess the stain.
Yeah, there's stains on the front of the gown. He said it's straight out of Kaiser. I mean, he stole the freaking thing, and then he writes on the front of it.
Yeah, my socks. Do I have like the socks they give you when you go to Kaiser?
Oh, you know which ones they are, right? The ones that have the little grip,
yeah.
So you don't slide,
around in the water.
That's what he's walking. That's what he's walking around in.
Everything he's wearing is going to the lab.
Yeah.
Yeah. No shit.
Walker was from Kaiser.
Yo. You can solve 3 crimes with that DNA.
I don't think Grissom could have figured that shit out, dude. What happened here? I don't know, man. Let him die.
Roy, did you just update your cover page?
No. I did it earlier today.
Oh, yeah. Look at you.
What happened?
He's all on stage.
Oh, that's from Bray. That was, I did that earlier. That was Bray last week.
God, look at you. You look good, dude.
Thanks, man. But although, you know, you've had a few beers, so.
I'm going to like it.
You're going to like it?
Yeah, no, like no. It. I'm going to like it.
Like it? Like it a big.
Like it.
Wow. Wow. So, hey, what the hell? I hear there's gifts.
Okay, gifts. Gift time.
Gift time.
Jesus. He cannot even squeeze his horn.
That horn is like going.
So you sound like Kevari now. Can't even squeeze your own horn. Use the other hand.
Oh.
Oh, shit. Yeah. I didn't do that. Oh, he did. There's another hand.
Scott.
Yeah.
Scott.
Yeah, here's a hand for you guys going through your this shit.
Hey, Scott, did you see the picture?
Are you talking about the clown? I'm talking,
yeah.
About,
yeah. Yeah, I'm looking at this.
Okay.
It's very scary.
I love the bag, too. It's
very scary. What the heck?
Dude, that bag.
We have a birthday bag.
Well, I don't know. That bag is.
It says breast wishes.
Breast wishes. He set it on the counter, and the counter went thud.
It did. Jeez.
So did that one.
You guys can find who gets what bag, but here, you can go through them and give you a little story behind them. But no, they're just gifts for you guys.
He brought us gifts.
You guys have worked hard a long time.
I'm so happy, Roy.
We have like, you know, kind of like.
I'm so happy, Roy, that I'm back here and you have to put your hand in those bags.
I don't. Well, no, we got to pick them. There's one for each of us. Which one do you want? Do you want breast wishes or do you want the clown happy birthday?
I'm doing breast wishes because I'm kind of tired of the clown thing right now. Right. It's a lot of clown.
So,
a lot of
you know what we
should
do right now is we should. Okay, you guys talk amongst yourselves.
All right, I'll come in.
Jimmy's coming in. I'm going to give him this thing. He's going to come and grab his. And then I'm going to grab mine. I don't know what's going on here.
I think you got the right one.
You think?
That thing weighs like a ton.
You said you could pick whichever one. What do you mean? I got the right one.
No, they're pretty much the same.
They're pretty much the same.
Shit. But, yeah.
Oh, you can put that one on, Jimmy.
Oh, here you go.
There you go. Here you go, Jimmy. He's picking it up with his shirt. All right, now Jimmy's running back to his thing. Okay, see what I got. Okay, so mine says happy birthday. It's got a clown on it. Looks kind of like the rupper. Oh, no, it's not rupper. I'm sorry.
It's Slappy.
Slappy. Sorry.
Thank you. I don't
Dan
know
Rupp's not here. No, that guy's not here. So I'm going to reach in and pull the first thing out. And I've got a...
Wow.
All right, you go first. What do you got?
It looks like a bottle of red urine.
That is Dan Rupp's reclaimed water from his shower that he recycles.
That's right. I'm done.
He puts that in the planter.
He puts it in the planter.
Yeah, but you could drink it, too.
No, we can't.
Oh my God.
No, that you don't drink, you submit.
So if you don't remember when he was on our show, he said he actually recycles his shower water to water his plants. And now we just got a bottle of it here.
Oh, yeah. Oh look, I got one too.
Yeah, you got one too there, Jimmy. That's nice.
I'm gonna, you know what I'm gonna do?
You know, we're gonna celebrate when we're done, like champagne. I'm gonna open it and we're gonna like put it all over everybody.
I'd rather have Marlins. What the hell? That
liquid ass.
Liquid ass. That's pretty much it. So now reach in for the second one. I don't know what this is. It's dude, it's a Hostess fruit pie.
Nice.
It's cherry too.
That's in a box?
Yeah, dude, it's sealed, so I'm not afraid to eat it.
Yeah, just don't look at the date. I don't know how old that is.
No, look at it. It's Best by September 18, 2015. And Jimmy got an apple.
I got one, but my box is open, so this thing's going right to the trash.
Well, mine might be open, but it's glued back together, so we're all right.
And when Roy says right. Jimmy got an apple, it doesn't mean like an Apple computer. You got an apple.
Roy.
No, an apple pie.
Roy, that's not glue.
Yeah, you get to... those cherry pies are great. So, you can stick your penis
in
them.
What's this?
Oh, that's my parking ticket. You can take care of that for me.
It is. Really a parking ticket.
Scott, this is nasty shit over here.
It's vehicle not on safe list, no visible permit. So he is actually really giving me his parking ticket.
Yeah, you can take care of that. You're welcome.
You can take care of that.
Serious.
That's a real
It's
ticket.
A real parking ticket. So we got her. So far I have his reclaimed bath water. Shower water, a parking ticket that I can take. Oh, and it's, you know, it's got one of those things on it where I could do the meta
yeah,
thing.
Yeah, just
where
gotta
you
scan it.
Scan it, and I can pay it right
yeah,
there.
Yeah, just pay with your credit card.
Two shade or Ernie, because Ernie's holding like a straight face. I'm ready to heave. Ernie's just holding a straight face. I'm ready to heave.
And a cherry fruit pie. So I'm reaching in again. Oh, there's something over here on the side. It's,
oh my God.
It's Cracker Jacks.
Yeah.
Taped up.
It's taped up. It's used Cracker Jacks.
No, it was taped from the box. See, because the.
You
the,
are.
The,
oh, hell
see,
no.
See, no, the perforation.
See if
no,
there's, a,
really,
see if
no,
there's a prize in there. See
it's
if there's
really,
a prize in
yeah,
there.
Yeah, there's a tattoo in
yeah,
there.
Yeah, it's called Clap. No,
I think I need to go to Kaiser to get treated for this shit. Oh, so let's check the date on this thing, right? Oh, this came with three boxes. So that's why it was taped together.
I got the second one.
Where's the third?
I'm looking for the date.
I ate the third one.
This is December 1st, 2015. So far the pie and the Cracker Jacks is...
Yeah, the pies are cool because you get to stick your penis in them. And...
Fuck.
No, I think I really.
The scary thing is, I think he already did, and that's why the box is taped back up.
Let me tell you, if I stick my penis in that, I'll split the box. Okay? Jesus.
Well, there's something in the bottom here. It's a.
Oh, that's.
It's a glow stick.
Yeah, there you go. We're gonna rave tonight.
Oh no, shit! We're gonna rave tonight. I just cracked it.
Well, I don't know what to do. I don't know. I'm not a big raver.
I'm not a big raver.
I don't know. It was at the 99 cent store, so I got it.
No expense was spared. I went to the 99 cent store.
These are lavish.
You
gifts.
Should stick this in your arm and run around saying,
"All right, so now
give me a Band-Aid."
Did you get one of those two there, Jimmy?
A glow stick? Let's see.
Reach in the bottom.
That might be.
Yeah, I got two.
Okay, I got something too.
If the stick's not glowing,
hey now, hey now.
I got.
What'd you get?
I've got 40 something magazine and XXX divorcees and gaping
that,
something.
That looks like Jane Fonda on the cover.
51 to 76.
It says right here, Katia 57 opens up her.
Are you listening with Jimmy's plane?
Turn around. Doesn't that look like Jane Fonda on the cover?
And it came with a DVD.
Yeah, DVD.
It's for adults only. Connie 56 is sloppy and wow.
Oh God.
Sloppy.
So this magazine is for ages 51 to 76 years old.
Yeah. That's our
and,
age.
And Duoxama is 51 and she likes a rough anal landing. So
compared to a smooth anal landing.
Yeah, smooth. It's wow, thanks, Dan. Thanks, Slappy.
You're welcome.
Well, our gifts were pretty well identical up until...
You didn't get a book?
I didn't get the 51 and older John Kevari technique of one hand slapping the monkey.
John's going to be calling us back right now wanting to see if he
he's
going to
actually...
Book.
That was my magazine. All right.
Oh, my God, Jimmy, that was good. I thought he really...
Is that Vasquez over there?
Oh, wait, I got two glow sticks. I got a blue one and a red one.
I'm missing a cherry pie.
Oh, shit.
My cherry pie has a hole in it.
All right, mi amigo. All right.
Wow. Hey, thanks.
But wait, up until that,
yeah,
we're identical.
Did
however,
you get a parking ticket, too?
Nope. However, my two on those gifts are a little different than yours.
Why is that?
I got
uh-oh.
A TV premiere DVD of Hanna-Barbera Superstars, The Jetsons.
Yeah.
It's wow, that was killer. How come I got the old ladies?
It's the microchip.
Lady!
It's the microchip.
Old lady!
Hey, lady!
Microchip chump episode, which I will cherish. And then I got something for that lady in the magazine. I have a unopened, weird, box of... Natureplex twin pack disposable douche.
Dude, you are insane.
Now, I'm wondering right now, though, is between everything we have in our house, there's nothing at home for Rhonda.
No.
Oh.
We've got the food. We've got the food and the douche.
Jimmy,
so.
Jimmy, can you imagine visual?
Oh, my God.
Visual. Him walking up to the counter with all this shit while he paid for it.
No, he probably wore the clown.
You wore the clown out when you got it, didn't you?
Yeah, I got to dress in disguise to buy all that shit.
Oh my God!
Wow, I am so happy. I have
I'm touched. Wow. I just don't know by who.
By ourselves later, apparently.
Well, I gotta tell you, I got some Cracker Jacks and a fruit pie.
Wait, one more thing.
Oh, he's got something else in there. Oh, don't think you were done.
An unopened box of tuna helper. why that's in a box with a douche?
Where the fuck did the tuna helper come from? Like, why?
It was on sale, $3.99. Right? I bought three. I took two. I gave one to Jimmy.
The hard decision for him was who got the douche.
Okay, yeah. I'm telling you right now, I'm going to rehab right now. I swear, I'm taking myself.
Got
right
the douche and the hamburger helper. Good night. Oh,
don't be surprised if Blaine's off the air tomorrow morning and there's a tent over the building
and a hand. We got a hand.
Yeah, I gave you a hand job.
What?
Wow.
That went weird.
Well, I got the hand in my hand.
Especially for the guys sitting next to him.
Maybe Kevari could have too if he had this one.
Oh, jeez. All right, Dan. Dan, thanks for coming in, buddy. I appreciate the gifts. And if I re-gifted this douche to my mom, I'll get my ass kicked. So there's no re-gifting going on. These are truly our gifts.
These are ours. They're definitely ours.
Yeah, they're yours. You could use them. I think guys could douche once. I don't know.
Wait. How?
No.
Obviously, Victor doesn't listen to the Blaine Humble show.
He's wearing a hospital gown. Don't show us.
Oh, he does have a hospital gown on the stand.
You want to go to the restroom and see? I'll show you. Oh, God. Got a second?
No.
Oh, yeah. Jimmy.
He's
Jimmy.
Like this. Yeah. Like,
wait, yeah. Give me one more beer and I might try this.
Wow.
Man, I really wish I was down there with you guys because I'm looking at this picture. Everybody needs to look at Roy Booster's Facebook to see Slappy because he looks like if Ronald McDonald was a pimp. he is so crazy looking.
Oh, shit. It does. Like I didn't think of that.
Like Wesley Snipes got together and had a gay kid.
I do kid parties too.
So. Yeah. That's good. I think maybe not. Holy shit, Jimmy! Break time. Get us out of here.
We got to get out of here.
Yeah,
Jimmy's got a douche, and I got to have an apple pie.
Obviously,
I needed a Corona from. Yeah. I needed a Corona.
Obviously, I need that fresh feeling after air. This.
Wow.
Hey, thanks, guys. No, congratulations.
Thanks for coming in, man.
It's a lot of fun.
Problem.
Appreciate it, brother.
All right, brother.
All right, man. We'll come up for the last half hour of the Roy and Jimmy thing here on kaoticradio.com.
We got a half hour left. You want to give us a call, 909-989-0789.
Give us a call. We've still got Scott on the line. I'm going to leave him there as long as he wants to stay.
This guy obviously doesn't have a track phone.
You know what? I have unlimited minutes, and right now I'm taking advantage of the man.
Yes, you are.
Taking advantage of the man. We're going to get out of here. We'll see you in a minute. And holy shit, I don't know what's coming up next, but we'll find out. See ya. Engage in a row, pump the rhythm, and we're like an active blower. Just for you and your crew, so you can taste the rhythm from the Latin active race. As it takes control of your body and soul, feel the physical change, and you'll be so. You can't stop what starts to take place. Your body starts to groove to the diddy dope bass. That's what happens, as you can see. Now let the crew explain the Latin activity. Welcome back to the Roy and Jimmy Thing anniversary special here on chaoticradio.com. We have lost all control and we don't give a shit. We can't get rid of this freaking clown. And I don't know what to do now.
bearing gifts and creepiness.
But we got some tuna helper and some Cracker Jacks. And
no, you got one tuna helper. He kept the other two.
They kept the other 99 cents for a 3-pack, so that's 33 cents a piece. And
we're bearing gifts, yes.
Yeah, no. You know,
hey, what is
no expenses too high?
Hey, the gift that keeps on giving.
Yeah, gift that keeps on giving. Where's our magazines?
Do we still have Scott on the phone?
Yeah, Scott's still on the phone. We got another phone calling in. Well, let's get the other phone too. Line one, you're on the air. Who? Whoop. Line one, you're on the air. Who's this? 40s. Line one.
Is that you talking to me?
Yeah. Oh, it's Gus.
Gus.
Oh, Gus, wow. Arizona. What's going on, Gus? You called us during break. That's why we put you on. We didn't know who you were.
Sorry, dude. Called when I could, man. I had it on my manscaping appointment tonight, so.
Yeah, well, you could have done it here. I think Slappy would have helped you with it.
No, well, Helga gives me half off when I do it on the off hours. So I, you know, I came down to the smooth kitty and went ahead and
the smooth kitty
to work on me, man.
What's going on, brother?
Not too much. Just called to wish you guys a happy anniversary.
Oh, appreciate it.
Gus has the honor of being our very first in studio guest. You were the very first one to grace our stage with your funniness and being our first guest. So appreciate that, buddy.
Yeah.
You know what? I wasn't aware of that.
So, Gus, you popped their cherry. Way to go, bud.
Yeah,
well. Yeah, and it'll never be the same.
Yeah, exactly.
Never.
You always remember your first, good or bad. Yeah,
good or bad. That's exactly right.
You were
exactly
first,
right.
Yeah, you were our first guest, and Dan was our first nightmare that we were awake for.
Yeah.
So, yeah, we've got some firsts going on tonight.
So, I've been listening to the show on and off in between waxings, and it's sounding good, man. A lot of funny stuff. A lot of great comics.
That's it. That's why we have you guys there. You're our friends. You're funny. Big Earn. You know Big Earn. You know Victor. That's
right. Yep.
Yeah.
And you know what? Good stuff.
And Scott.
Comics. I mean, that's all. That pretty much sums up the whole year, doesn't it?
I think it does.
Yeah. It just bunch of, and I said it before earlier tonight. Just. You know, we get to come here and just have fun with the guys we like to hang with. So that's what's cool.
The whole camaraderie of our comic buddies, our group, I think it's freaking blast.
Yeah, yeah.
Agreed. Agreed.
No, except for the freaking clown. But otherwise than that, we're all right.
Yeah. Yeah. We were good till the clown came. But, hey, the clown brought gifts.
Well, you can't be too mad at the clown that'll be spraying again.
Yeah, I don't know. Ernie's having a little too much fun with the MILF magazine.
Dang, right? It's pretty raunchy there.
Wait, and it comes with a DVD, right?
Yeah.
It does. It's called Cougar Trap.
Yeah. We had to ask Blaine. We had to throw that DVD in one of the computers here at the station and just watch it explode. got to be some good stuff on that.
$5 Kevari's on that DVD.
Well,
hi guys, it's me.
No, just the left side.
Wow.
Yeah, I went there. Hey, Gus, I'm six beers in, baby.
Yeah, I've been listening, dude. Yeah, you know what? I'm pretty good for six beers. I'd probably be on the floor already.
He's aware.
Not around no clown you'd want to be the
floor. Yeah, that's for damn sure. Yeah, clown stuff in here. And we got another guest. I mean, this is a double guest coming in. We still have Scott on the phone. Scott's been on the phone for an hour and 12 minutes.
Scott's
I heard, yeah. Yeah, Scott, world record.
Yeah, hey, Scott's our,
hey, Scott, if you're on the phone, who's covering the restaurant?
Don't you guys catch up and do all your cleaning and pressing and starching and shit this time of day?
Yeah, somebody out front's waiting for their Kung Pao chicken. They're really pissed off.
Yeah. And then we had a call that said some nice stuff, and now he's in studio, not going to say anything nice at all. But we got CFO in the house now.
What up? Can I open the MILF?
You can open it whatever you want, man.
Can I open MILF magazine?
I like that everyone kind of like just kind of like went around, and Ryan's like, dude, I'm going to open this. I'm going to open this shit up right now.
There's like it's a magazine with 67-year-old women.
It's interesting.
It's creeping me out.
The first one
mom.
Who said
Juan looks like Jane Fonda.
The first one who says mom, we're shutting it down.
Yeah, no shit, right? Could you imagine? That would be scary.
What would be scary if my mom was to call?
Yes.
Oh, talk about your weenus.
My weenus, yeah.
Now your weenus isn't getting excited, is
well,
it?
I don't know. He's popping open this magazine. Oh, there's two of them. Look at that.
Oh, it's a double magazine.
Well, mine is 50-plus miles.
Alicia is a 40-year-old mom's naughty toy story, but she's not 40. She's pushing 60.
She's a gilf for gilf.
Yeah.
That's a gilf.
Yeah.
Oh, Jesus.
She's a...
This, now I know why Dan bought the magazine.
Hey, my God.
Man up. The first open of
first
the page.
First page. Man up.
You want
Jesus.
Inside the cover was LJ Montanajo. LJ. LJ Montanejo on the front with a big old clown.
You ever seen a girl with zero areola but all nipple? So, she looked like she got a friggin'.
It looks like the sausage that goes on a pizza.
What do you call those little licorice things? Those little licorice bites?
Yeah, and licorice bites.
Yeah.
Licorice bites. Nips.
Nips. Yeah, her nips are nips. Her nips are nips.
Hey, you didn't go to get nips with Scott. Yeah, Scott on the other side. Hey.
Hey, sorry. Sorry. He's angry. Look right here. Angry.
Yeah, he's angry because that's the only job he can get.
No nips. No nips.
Wow.
I'm so glad you guys met my kid's nanny.
That's great.
My kid's nanny came in and brought milk.
He brought gifts.
Well, the creepiest mother ever on the planet. I think this is LJ right here.
Well, basically the presents he brought Ryan was basically his resume. This is how I babysit.
Who's this clean cut young gentleman that just came in?
Yeah.
I thought you took the makeup off.
No, well now we got another guest because we have Dan.
Hey, Dan Rupp's here.
Dan Rupp's here tonight.
I'm telling you, Dan looks what like happened? Steve O when he's 50.
That's the biggest compliment you've ever given anybody. Like
50. Oh, shit. He looks like Steve O.
Jackass, the plus years.
I never put that together. That's look freaking hilarious.
Right? Damn.
Oh my! You need to get a tattoo of your face on your back.
Hey, Scott, am I right? I mean, look at him.
Yeah, he does. He does.
Pictures. I can't see him through the monitor.
Oh, we get a
picture. Hey, follow Comer 16 on Periscope.
You built this shit. You should see.
Comber 16.
16 on Periscope.
We're periscoping him right now.
Hey, speaking about Facebook and stuff like that, why in the F did Jimmy Shaw post his feet?
Because he said the flip flops made his big toe look too big. It was gross.
I hate nasty feet. I was like ready to
hear. Hey, it wasn't nasty feet. You just hate feet.
No. The second toe was bigger than your big toe.
Oh yeah, I got that.
I got that going on too.
Here, I'll freak. You want me to freak? You want me to freak you out?
Yo, look at that toe.
Want me to freak you out? It's only that foot. The other one's normal.
Oh, now you're really
wow.
No, but no, that's not that bad. But when that sucker sticks out like he's the starting center for the Lakers.
Oh, shit.
He's putting it on.
You just got towed by the CFO.
I need some tuna helper.
you need the douche. You need the douche. We're going to wash it down.
You know the funny thing? My family, my entire family knows I hate like feet, like when you spread it like a web, and he just put his foot on me.
Take these pictures and cut them out and just get some, if you guys have scotch tape.
Janice, they're killing me over here, Janice.
Just tape them like by like an old couple's booth.
You want to see creepy feet? You've seen these guys' feet? This guy's feet.
This guy's feet?
It looks like three tree trunks, but he only has
Jimmy stood up on the other. Dude, you got stand up there on the deal. Get your cankle on display.
Those are not cankles. Those are freaking.
It's called water retention.
So what? That's not water. What? Do you need the douche? Yeah, water retention problem.
Wow.
That's a tsunami tension. What the hell are you talking about?
Jesus.
You know, we have a drought that could really help us out.
Why don't you drain that?
Scott, you got to see these ankles, my God.
You would help the Hoover
Dam. We got a drought.
Take the pictures of them. I got to see
these.
Somewhere there's redwood trees that aren't
buried.
Oh, my God.
Oh, shit.
Scott, if we squeeze these ankles over a reservoir, we had everything solved.
You have a forest fire. We just hang you out and milk your feet.
At least water your plants with that shit.
Oh, now I know why the water from the bathwater was orange. It was out of his feet.
Dude,
oh man,
dude, you look as sexy as an Armenian grandmother.
Wow. Hey, Gus, you know what? Yeah. I just realized why I know you didn't want to be in studio all of a sudden. You just wanted to call.
All right, Scott.
Gus, can you come pick me up?
I just messaged Scott the ankles.
Did you? Oh, I want to see Scott's opinion. Oh, yeah. Wow, right?
That is wild. There's like one continuous, it's like a ham or something.
Two hams. No, we're periscoping it right now. You have no...
Wow. When did this turn into the Stern Show? Holy cow.
I know.
Wow. We got porn on the table. We've got cankles for days.
No, it's not cankles. That's water retention problem.
Okay, well, we got those ankles in here. We got porn on the table.
Dude, how do you get your shorts on? Does it, stretch over your ankles first and go up? Or... I got cankles, all right? I'm a fat guy.
How does he fit his ankles through this?
That's what I'm wondering.
Hey, you should see Roy's, though. It's like the Redwood Forest.
Break him out, Roy. Let's see yours.
I'm a fat ass, and your ankles are bigger than mine.
Let's see him.
But I don't have a water retention problem. I'm taking my Mito.
Those are big legs, man.
So I don't have a problem. You got to try that.
I take Lasix, okay?
Lasix. Isn't that the shit you do for your eyes?
That doesn't help your feet, bro. I don't know what they told you.
It gets your shitty outlook on things, but it doesn't change anything.
He's fine. He goes, oh, well, shit, that's the fucking problem.
I can see great, but my feet are jacked.
I can't see what's underneath me because my feet are in the way.
You know what you remind me of? Was it the Wizard of Oz that the trees were into the ground with their big old trunk feet? Right there. Throwing apples at Toto. Uh-oh, we got another line. Oh, man, we got another call coming in. This thing's going in.
Hey, this is the
line three. You're on the air.
Oh, my God. Hello?
Yeah, hello?
Is this Jimmy or Roy?
This is Roy.
This is us, buddy.
Oh, dude, what's up, brother?
What's up, man? I'm sorry. I was at an open mic and got caught up. Just wanted to call real quick and tell you guys congratulations on the one-year anniversary.
Hey, thanks, man.
Awesome show, man.
Oh, Sean Williams, thank you so much for calling in, buddy. How you been?
Is this a black guy?
Is this a black guy? That was my favorite quote of all. Favorite quote. Yeah, they were all in studio, and all of a sudden we hear Ryan. Sean's black.
No, he looked up.
I had to pull a black move today. No. It's late.
You had to be late.
That is so new.
He's scared of dogs and he can't swim. That's all right.
There you go,
bro.
Shit.
Do you remember that show?
Sorry, that was not Roy. That was Roy Brewster.
No, that wasn't me, Sean. I'm trying to help you here, and it's not me because you give me shit all the time, and it wasn't
never
me.
Never pull a racist stunt like that.
Friggin' Jimmy.
Hey, wait, hold on. We cannot make fun of Roy anymore because I've done that. His girlfriend's not talking to me.
Wait. We got to introduce Sean. Everyone's here. We got Big Ern in the studio, buddy. We've got Victor Vasquez, the CFO, Ryan Combe, me, Roy, Blaine, this clown named Dan, and on the phone we have
Sean.
Gus. We have Gus Arredondo and Scott Shimamoto.
Wait, what's Gus's last name?
Arredondo.
No, Arredondo.
Go ahead and say it again, Jimmy.
No, I'm not gonna.
He's Arredondo.
Are you or that guy?
What the hell is Arredondo?
I'm not gonna.
It's Arredondo.
Sorry, not gonna.
You gotta roll the R's, man.
Yeah. Gotta roll the R's.
Arredondo.
So Sean called in on Full House night.
Right on, Sean. That was cool. You made some time for us. It's, you know, that's cool.
Sean's fucking hilarious.
I'm sorry I missed it, man. I should have called earlier, man.
No, you're blowing up everywhere, man. I know you're working. We're just doing this shit, and you're out there, really
Sean,
doing it.
Sean's fucking hilarious.
Who said that?
Victor Vasquez.
That was Vic.
I'll back that up. Victor Vasquez said that. You're fucking hilarious.
Oh, man, that's why you haven't booked me.
So that's why he hasn't booked
me. I don't book blacks.
Oh, shit.
I feel you, man.
Brian told me to say that. Brian told me to say that.
You know what? He was afraid you were going to come late.
No, I'm just kidding. Hey, I had Key on my show. I had Cam. I started naming all of them all of a sudden. I had them all.
That's why black dudes are good in porn, because they always come late.
No. See that? I've never been late, man. I wear Argyle sweaters.
Hey, you come early. Hey, Sean, I tried to book you, but you said you couldn't make it that day. Because you're already...
Oh, yeah, because you called me like an hour before the show. You're like, hey, man, I have a dropout. Can you do it? I'm like, no. He said, I'm serving free chicken. I was like, Phil, no.
Hey,
best friend Tyson, didn't he?
Hey, but...
Yeah, you know what?
I wasn't lying, though.
I got off the phone and I heard him say, Pichi Mayate.
That's what he did, man.
No, but you know what?
So who's dressed up in a clown suit? I saw the photo.
Oh, my
who's
God. That? Damn.
That was Slappy. That's nobody in the suit. That was Slappy the Clown.
Did you see
that? That was Brett?
No, I didn't.
No, that was Rupper. Oh, that was Dan. Man.
Yeah.
Right when Dan got here, the clown left.
Yeah, the clown. You never see Dan and the clown in the same place.
Okay. All right. Well,
yeah, just a real freak show. Real freak show you missed on that one, buddy.
Yeah.
Cool. Anyway, man, I'm going to get off here. You know, brothers, have a good night. I'm going to listen to the rest of the show, however much long you guys have. But wanted to call in. Congratulations on 1 year anniversary. I'm going to toss one back for 2 years. How about that?
Right on, brother.
Thanks, Sean. Great comic, great friend. Catch him whenever you see
class
he's playing.
That's a class act right there. That's a class act right there.
Hey, Sean, love you, man. Yo, thanks, brother.
Care. What's that mean? Wait.
What?
What's that?
What?
Was that Sean's exit music or yours?
That wasn't me, man. He has his own exit music. He does his own shit. Wow. He goes to get off the phone, he goes one of these.
That's just Sean's exit music.
That's what Sean does.
There's no show following you. Why are you leaving?
Because, you know, we're running late already. Look at Ryan's like, no one's here.
Hey, that's your boss, dude.
I'm your boss.
I'm your boss. Talk some more shit, funny man.
Say funny shit.
Say funny shit. That's what we like to be here for.
Even though I haven't seen you on stage, say something.
Yeah, say something. Entice
the bloated clown is gone. You need to be funny.
I need to be funny. Yeah.
You're up, buddy. You're up.
Yeah, I'm done. Yeah, it'd be funny.
No pressure.
I like that. My Jimmy's favorite. I love Jimmy's favorite joke to that. When someone goes, "Hey man, say something funny." Go ahead.
Fuck you.
Yeah. That's what Jimmy says. Knock knock. Who's there? Fuck you. Love that one, dude. Scott, you are like a record at 126.
I'm telling you, 3 minutes. I'm taking advantage of the man.
No track phone.
Yeah, and Gus is laying back going, man, honey, I told you, Lori, I told you I didn't need to go down there. You know those guys are crazy.
Gus and Sean are both thankful they didn't come down here.
Well, because they don't fit.
Oh, my God.
Damn.
Shit. Yeah.
Wait, who said that? Who said that?
That was
me. Dude, CFO, my bad.
Oh, my God.
You got to work with those guys again. You're going to be on stage with them, for sure.
Oh, shit. It really just
went. And I'm going to be at church tomorrow at 10 in the morning.
Yeah, it's my favorite, right? He's going to be at church tomorrow at 10 in the morning. Yeah, yeah. You needed this, man.
Bless me, Father, for I have sinned.
I gotta be at a funeral tomorrow. Dude.
Yeah.
Fucking...
Really? Yeah, seriously. Yeah.
I do. That's why I'm out here. I gotta be. Oh, never mind.
Rest in peace, Slappy's feet.
Definitely bury those.
Bury those. Need two caskets.
Dude, I felt like getting on one of those and going down a waterfall. I thought it was
log ride at Disneyland.
That might have been my favorite line I've ever heard in chaotic history. He said, he's got the drought problem solved.
Well, his legs, they look like logs. Like two logs.
Fucking full of water.
If you ever want to know how old Dan is, just cut his legs off and count the rings. I didn't know he was that old.
Oh my God.
No, he looks way older than the ring.
Way older than the ring.
Hey, ever since Kevari was on, we've been going to hell.
Yeah. Well, that's usually the way a show goes.
We're going to hell.
He starts it though. He starts that downward trend and then it's all over.
When I said we're gonna book him on Broadway as Nemo, that was it. Gus, right?
Gus is still there. He's like,
yeah,
he's like,
yeah.
The voice of reason is Gus and Dennis. The only two people that made any sense.
No, Gus makes you like voice of reason. Such make you feel bad for shit you say.
Yeah. Yeah, but that's the evilest laugh you've ever freaking heard in your life. Right now, he's figuring every way he can put all this shit behind us and like get us all in trouble for it somehow. See, there it was again.
I've heard that freaking sinister.
I'm looking at this cougar porn right now. I'm so happy. I feel so much better as an American that it's 100% recyclable. This DVD it says go green, 100% recyclable. Right in the middle.
Oh, Jesus. That reminds me of the records you used to get on the back of the cereal boxes. Remember those things?
Yeah, yeah. You just cut them out.
And you cut them out and put them on your player.
And they work.
Your needle's like bumping up and down.
Yeah.
Hey, my whole family's listening. They're cracking their asses.
Well, I'm glad we're making them happy. I mean, as long as that happens.
Oh, no. They're all adult. Well, I don't know. Well, children dress like 12, 13. They're listening. Yeah.
The Hispanic community, that's enough to be pregnant. That's enough to be old.
That's true.
They might have grandkids by now. Yeah.
No. I had a sister that had a quinceañera and a baby shower at the same day.
Didn't know whether to buy a stroller or never mind. yeah, that's Slappy bring this? Slappy brought the hand. He said he used it to masturbate.
He did in the video.
In the video, that's
in the
what
video.
He,
you gotta see the video.
Get it off of my damn phone. Woo, boy. That was not good.
Happy anniversary, dude.
Thanks, man.
Jesus.
Damn.
What the hell?
We're still
going. And CFO came all the way from the Angel game.
I did.
From them getting their ass left early. No, on the phone.
No, he called.
Yeah, and called.
So he's been on the show. See, I want to do that. I want to be on the show by phone and live.
See, yeah. That's the first.
Right. I was in a different county, and I sucked you off from a different county. Now I'm here to suck you off live. Wow. You guys are the greatest thing on this station that you keep this shit going. Your energy, I told you before, don't want to say it again, but...
But that's what
like the energy that you guys have for this shit, you still love everything you freaking do. You could have a million listeners out there or 20 or 1,000, and you're going to do it because you love being in the same room with your boyfriend. But you guys are funny MFers. I love you both.
You may be right on the 20, so I do appreciate it.
Yeah, we're probably pretty close to the 20, right? Wow.
But you're definitely about the boyfriend.
But that's why they have us in two different rooms, so we got to keep our hands off each other on air.
Yeah, keep your hands off him.
Yeah, because you guys can't suck each other on air. That's just pornographic.
Really? Really? The one-year anniversary show, Victor will never be back. No, he could just pull me and say, you know, get booked and not show up. So it's the same shit.
You got to, I mean, well, no, you did the diabetes show, and you fucking rocked it.
Yeah, we had a good time.
No, you killed it. You had a good time. Jimmy did a great job.
Yeah, I had a good time.
Yeah, that was fun. I wanted to get, Scott there, but, you know, I don't hire Asians either. <Just kidding. laughs>
It's okay. We work for free.
So why didn't you get Gus in?
We had a size limit.
Oh, that was shit.
That was like a volleyball set. Now I know why
I haven't been invited.
Now he knows why. I know I'm not there.
No, either. Ernie, I'm inviting you to my next outdoor event.
Yeah, the wing pit and me just would not happen.
This thing just went to shit. You know that, don't you?
Hey, Jimmy, I love Roy's face when I say something like that. He's like, oh, that's wrong.
Yeah.
That's all shit. Right? And I'm the one that always catches shit for saying.
What are you talking about? Your old lady won't even talk to me anymore because I make fun of you.
That's right.
I like the old.
What'd I say? Now you did it.
I love the old days.
Now you're in trouble again because you called her my old lady.
Yeah. Hey, Jimmy, don't you like the old days when, you know, we could make fun of Roy and nobody gave a shit?
I do miss those days, yes. Now he's got all these defenders.
No, she blasted me on Facebook because I made fun of her man and I made fun
damn
of her.
Right. See?
You know, shit.
First you made fun. No, this is what happened. First you picked on me, and then you picked on the Angels.
Yeah.
And then she had enough.
I think the Angels is actually came first
right?
in anger.
That, you see, Ryan's like, "Atta girl."
Hey, no, but
and he hasn't even heard her rap for dogging on me, man. Just wait.
Right. Yeah, go ahead.
She loves Gus.
Yeah, she does. But bag on Gus. See what happens.
No, I just did. She's going
The phone's going to ring any minute now, and she's going to rip your ass right here. As a matter of fact, we should get off the air, but right now, if she's going to call, I'm going to take that damn call.
Don't. You're a dick.
You're a dick.
And here's the best part.
She's listening right now. She's
probably
gonna call.
Is. So here's the deal. She loves Jimmy.
Yeah.
She loves Big Ern.
Yeah.
She loves Ryan.
She's known me the longest.
Yeah. No, Ryan the longest. Yeah. Gus and Ryan the longest. Gus longer.
Gus longer. Yeah,
and then Ryan. Now, I got on this train a little late, so that leaves only one person that she's going to rip when she calls.
Fucking Dan.
Let's not even talk, not even talk about how she feels about Scott.
Yeah. Yeah, she loves Scott.
Who doesn't love Scott?
Dude? Everybody.
Right.
You know?
Of course she did. He's the guy who did my homework in school.
Well, the one thing we did add this year is a few months ago, we added a thing we like to call the Roy and Jimmy thing, Great Eight Quiz. Victor, you've taken it.
Oh, I've taken it.
Oh, we got to get CFO to do it.
You did the best. So far, I'm going to say my vote for the best impression is you.
You think so?
Oh, yeah. Dude, I actually got it queued up.
Oh, do you have that?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Watch.
Here we go.
I said the F word.
I'm begging him to say a cuss word. He thinks he's still at Luna.
Wait for it. It's coming.
Oh, my God.
All right. Our last question for you guys.
Here it is.
And I have to call your name for this one. Your best impression you do. It doesn't have to be a famous person, just somebody you know. And we're going to start with Victor.
Sometimes I do Bernie Mac.
Let's hear it.
Them motherfuckers. Them motherfucking kids. Fuck them motherfucking kids. Them motherfucking kids are crazy. I'm upstairs like I ain't got a name.
He did that sober too.
Yeah, I love to hear him do it now. We had to get Ernie or Ryan to do this.
Have you done the Great A's, Ernie?
No, I haven't done it.
Ryan obviously hasn't.
I haven't.
Yeah.
Am I supposed to just do my best impersonation?
No. You got to answer all eight questions.
No,
okay. They're serious questions. You got to do.
Yeah, we're running over time, so let's end the show.
The Great Eight Quiz.
The Great Eight Quiz.
I'm not worthy of ending your show, but I'll do it.
Okay,
yeah, absolutely.
And I'm gonna. It's a series of eight questions. They're very random. There's no correct answers. Whatever comes to your mind, that's it. And I'm gonna call out each person's name. We'll do the questions at the same time.
Oh, so okay. It's not just me.
No,
you and Ernie.
Big Ern is going to do it. He's been here. He's been a guest twice, and this came in after his second show. So, and Gus again, the very first guest on the show to take the Great Eight Quiz. Yep. So Gus is number one on two things right
there. Number one.
Yeah. The first.
First.
Okay. Are we ready?
Let's do it.
I guess.
All right, Gus and Ryan, it's time to take the Great Eight Quiz.
Is it me, Ernie, and Gus?
No, yeah. Gus already.
I'm confused.
Did. Yeah,
Ernie. So this is the two of you. Yeah, you both answer.
Yeah, Ernie's next to you.
So shut up, Gus.
So I'll call your name out after I ask the question, and then you answer. Okay. Question number one. Ernie, Letterman or Leno?
Letterman.
Ryan.
Same question.
Yeah.
Oh, Letterman.
Okay.
Kimmel.
Okay. Question number two. Fucking good. Ernie, you're first. What is your chill music? What do you escape to?
Sinatra. Love Frank Sinatra.
Look at you, swag.
Yeah.
Nice. Mr. Ryan.
My chill music?
Hey, we already know.
I want to hear it. What is it?
What are you going to say it is?
What am I going to say it is?
This is your question.
I want to hear your answer is for my chill music.
Yeah.
My chill music? Neo.
Oh, shit.
Neo.
All right.
Neo. Wow.
Look at this
that
guy.
That threw me off.
I'm blacker than anybody you know. Including Sean Williams.
Blacker
sorry.
Sean.
Sorry, Sean. He thinks I'm the most racist bastard ever, but I'm just black and I can sympathize.
He just thinks.
I feel you.
God damn. All right. Question number three. This may not apply to Ryan, but I think I can make this work. What is Ernie? What is your comic inspiration?
Don Who? Rickles.
Don Rickles.
Oh, I like it.
Yeah. Very nice. You're very old school. I like.
I
that.
Am, and that's.
I love that guy.
I actually wanted to be a comedian because I would see him on those infomercials for the Martin Rose.
Yeah,
and I just fell in love with him. And I did meet him probably in early 2000.
Get the fuck out of here!
And we're at a casino in Highland. I'm not going to say it because they're not paying me. So I go up to him, like, oh, my God, that's Don Rickles.
In Highland, I wonder which one it was.
Yeah. So before I'm probably like 4 feet from him, and he stops me and he goes, hang on a second. He goes, Mexican fella, right? And I go, yes. And he goes, Jesus Christ, what did you do with the rest of the taco truck? So ever since then, I've loved the guy.
That is verification. Wow.
Legendary shit talker. I probably would have said him too. I'm gonna go with Brian Regan.
Oh, he's so great.
Nice. Yeah.
Except I dropped too many F bombs. He's clean. How can you be that funny and be clean?
right?
That's cool though. That's yeah. that's tough.
Props yeah. to him.
Regan. Regan.
Well,
is
Cosby
hilarious.
Can, but then he'll fucking molest you.
Yeah. take this pill. With your jello pudding, paps.
Put the pudding in your...
That's what happens when you keep it in. Keep it in like that all that time, and then it comes out.
Who was just doing the Cosby impersonation? Was that you, Ernie?
No, that was me.
That was pretty good.
That's pretty good.
You put the pills near the pussy.
was that Jimmy?
Yeah, that was Jimmy.
I was wondering.
Wow. Way to go, Jimmy.
I was wondering where that came from.
You give him a pill so you get the pussy.
The whitest bastard in this room just dropped.
You could close your eyes and you would have thought Bill Cosby was in the other room.
All right, it was me. Lighting.
All right, okay. Question number four. Ernie, what is your go-to comedy movie?
You know, I've heard a lot of the go-to comedy movies, and they're all my favorites. And the one I've always heard the most is Kingpin. But I'm going to kind of switch it up. I'm going to switch it up with the Shocker. And I'm going to say my
favorite. Two in the Pink, One in the Stink? That one? No.
That's a Shocker.
Two Girls in One Cup? No. No, my favorite go-to, this will be a Shocker, is The Cannonball Run.
Dude, that's a great movie.
Okay.
You know what the shocker would be? If he jogged home.
Oh, shit. My truck is like 50 yards. That's a challenge right there.
God damn.
I think we've had enough earthquakes in California. We don't need to jog.
Hey, Aaron, I'm out in the parking lot now, and I'll be waiting for you. That way we can
take your picture. Then, hey, if you came down here, we'll call that the Cannonball Run.
Was that whole thing a setup?
No.
Did you guys plan that?
No, it was like perfect.
Are you serious?
I'm improvising.
That was scripted.
Okay.
That was scripted. Okay, I'm calling you out.
Ryan,
that was too good.
Ryan, your go-to comedy movie.
Three Amigos all day long.
Yes.
Love Three Amigos.
Excellent.
Oh, shit. In the bar when the guy comes in, the German guy starts shooting the plates up.
When they thought it was fake?
Yeah. Look at the two little sissies.
I fucking love that.
Oh, it's a...
My little buttercup.
It's a sweater.
Today, El Guapo is 33 Guapo. Years old.
I'm on Netflix that this weekend with my kids.
Are you greatest?
No, I like it when he goes, Jefe, what is a plethora?
How can you tell me I have a plethora when you don't know what it means to have a plethora? Jefe, I am... No, he says, El Wap, I am sorry, but I do not have your superior intellect.
Would you like to kiss me on the veranda?
No.
No, lips would be fine.
Dude, I haven't seen that thing in probably...
So great.
I bet it's been 10 years.
Oh, you got to watch it.
Oh, I got to watch Brilliant. It.
What's funny is he goes, I'm still here at Wapo.
What is this? Gringos falling from the skies?
And then like another one falls.
Yes, El Wapo. Yes.
Ernie has great impressions.
Yeah.
He's killing it.
Oh, shit.
Are you a little netty? Netty Niederlander?
Niederlander.
Oh, shit.
How can you tell it's a male plane?
You see the little balls? Yes. Have you guys all performed ever in the same stage? Same night?
Me, Roy, and Ernie, and then me, Roy, and Victor.
The only way, yeah. Those,
you're the common denominator, Jimmy?
Yeah, I haven't done anything with Ernie, but I've been with the...
You've been with what?
Wait, Scott?
I have never been with a man like Ernie.
I would be with you, but you have nasty feet, fucker.
Who's Scott's on the line?
Scott's still here. Scott's at an hour and 42 minutes.
Wow. Yeah. What's Scott's last name?
Shimamoto.
Really?
Yeah. Really.
Come on, Mika. It's a school night, guys.
It rhymes with come moco.
You sound as Asian as Sean Williams sounds black.
Oh! Okay, come on. Wow. Bring us some, Scott. Come on.
Asian?
Yeah.
show him how you drive. crash it into something.
Yeah,
crash into
periscope something. That shit. Let's see it.
He'd destroy me.
No, he's got a video out on how to properly use chopsticks.
Oh,
he does.
Seriously.
Yeah, he does, really.
No, wait. You got to hear this. He has a rap song.
Yeah, he raps.
He raps, yeah.
Do I need, you need a beat?
No, he doesn't. He's
here it is right here. Oh. Jimmy's got it.
That's his song. Watch.
That's listen. Him.
I'm like the sun rising up in the morning.
Oh, you see, drop the
you
M-bomb.
Drop the N-bomb.
Drop the N-bomb.
That's right up Brian's alley. NWA. Boom.
Hey, and he's like, he goes, oh, he ain't got shit.
Go ahead, Jimmy. Show him the picture now.
Oh, yeah, oh, right. Show
him the- Here's the picture. Here's back in his rapping days. The one on the right.
Hey, it's instead of vanilla ice, that's Chino ice.
It's Chino rice.
We lost Gus.
No, Gus is Gus gave up.
Oh, Gus. Gustavo. Yeah.
Oh, man. What number were we on?
Okay, number five.
Number five. Oh, shit. Okay. I forgot.
Ernie, last thing that pissed you off. Could be major, minor, doesn't matter.
Oh, last thing that
last thing that pissed you off.
Hometown clothes. Who's that dick that keeps talking?
Who's that dick?
Okay. I'm gonna have to say it was Victor.
I'm just gonna say Victor for now. I can't think of. Oddly enough, that's my dad's favorite restaurant. Dad, you want to go to Fleming's? You want to go to Lucille's? Nah, let's go to Hometown.
Balling.
Honestly, I would probably have to say work. Work always pisses me off.
Gotcha. Fair enough.
I'm with you on that.
Ryan, besides the Angel game tonight.
Yeah, that, I was going to say that. No, last thing that pissed me off is the main man of this radio station sympathizing with all the assholes who want to kill cops.
What?
Fuck you, Blaine.
Wow, we got all serious. Oh, just killed a buzz like in 2 seconds, right?
Woo-hoo, party! Give me a beer now. Oh, jeez.
Wow, I didn't hear that one. Oh. Half my family are law enforcement.
I work for law enforcement. Yeah.
Did you say half your family are held by law enforcement?
No, they're in law enforcement.
Just because you're in the back of a car doesn't mean you're in law enforcement.
No, we tune up the cars.
Okay. Just because you make license plates.
Hey, they can't catch anybody if it doesn't work.
Right? Hey, man, I got a quick tip. Hey, yeah, do some shit tonight.
What? Wow.
All right.
Sorry, that was really a buzzkill. I didn't mean it for me.
Back to the quiz. Question number six.
Six.
Ernie, pizza leftovers, cold or warmed up?
Cold.
Atta baby.
Ryan?
Pizza warmed up, spaghetti cold.
Threw a twist in there. Very nice. Well, the correct answer is yes to all.
Yes.
Yes. Yes, please.
Yes. Yes to all. Okay. Question number seven. Ernie, your favorite cuss word?
Shit.
Ryan.
Really? I got to go big. Go big or go home, cunt.
That's it.
Drop it. Yes. Drop it.
Yes. Nice.
See you next Tuesday.
Okay. And the question number eight of the Roy and Jimmy Great Eight Quiz. And you guys know it's coming. Earn your best impression. Doesn't have to be famous. Doesn't have to be great. Your favorite. Everyone has one they do. Yep. What is yours? We just heard a few of them.
Yes, the one impression I did when I did the guest spot with Gabriel Iglesias, I did an impersonation of Vin Scully.
Ooh. Whoa.
Oh.
All right, turn me on.
I said, wouldn't that be cool when Vin Scully retires, he keeps that voice going and becomes a DJ at a strip club?
Yes.
Can you imagine going to
give him some quiet for this. I'm going to have to pull this off the tape. So, okay. Whenever
now, just
you're
imagine
ready.
You're at the Spearman Rhino. You hear, "Hello, everybody. This is Vin Scully coming to you live from the Spearman Rhino. Tonight we got 2-for-1 lap dances with a $5 2-for-steak dinner, and we also got all the best lap dances. Now coming to the stage is Caitlin, born and raised in Ontario, California. She wanted to become a lawyer, but had a child at 13, took up drugs, and became a stripper."
Can you imagine telling the story of a stripper like he does with the player?
That's awesome, dude.
It's just like, wow.
Dude, I was excited. I wanted to meet her.
Caitlin, though. Really?
Caitlin? I don't know. It just came
she,
to me.
Does she have an Adam's apple?
I don't. Well, let me see. Hang on. How about I'm looking at the magazine here. Alicia. Ontario. 40-year-old, old and naughty. Toy store. No.
That's classic.
And, I just went along with it, and sometimes I do it on stage.
Caitlin.
Dude, that's awesome.
It's just whatever.
Born in Ontario.
Dude, you sounded like Rod Serling. <He's> like, he did. Born in Ontario. Twilight.
Oh, that's born awesome. Ryan, Ontario. you got one in the pocket.
I have two and they both suck, but you guys can tell me which one's better. First, I'll do
Someday We'll Find It. The Rainbow Connection. The Lovers. The Dreamers. And Me.
Or I have it's terrible. It's terrible. Sorry. He's laughing. It's so terrible. My kids like it.
I never thought that was going to... I'm all thinking...
Shit, he likes it. I got two more.
Kirby, drink a beer and you'll sound a lot better.
Okay, I got... That's my other horrible one. And then my last one is...
I found a cure for the plague of the 21st century, but I've lost it.
It was terrible. Should I stick with Kermit?
Sean Connery, right?
Yeah.
Hey, Kermit.
Go with Kermit.
Kermit was the deal.
That was like,
Hey, remember when he sings the mystery?
Why do birds
that was.
Come on, Ryan. You got to hit that one.
His Kermit was, was like
every
Bernie Mac.
Time. You are near.
Oh, that's better. His Kermit's way better.
Close to you.
Yes. I'm the worst Kermit in the room, and that was my go-to.
Kermit. Oh, Kermit.
Miss Piggy would be pissed off. She'd be like, Kermit, don't drink up your damn beer. Kermit, just lick my pussy.
Oh, shit. What? Wow. Did I go over the edge?
Hey, Roy, happy anniversary.
Shit. Sorry.
Happy birthday.
Roy, you got a couple more questions.
I was saying that because frogs have long tongues.
No, that's it?
Vic, just so you know, that was eight. Ocho. That's grade eight quiz.
No,
so
what do you do with it? Is there right answers?
I went to continuation. You're fucking talking to me.
Wow.
That was great. That was...
Are there right answers?
Yeah, no, they were all right. You scored. You did well.
What was the score?
Who won?
Oh, wait.
The Dyers.
Scott, what's the score?
Nice. Yeah, give it to the Asian guy to add it up. Come on, Scott, what's the score?
Yeah, I don't have my calculator.
Abacus, something?
He's like, negative to the 5 to plus 2.
Wow. Oh, wow. Shit. That was a good grade eight.
That was a very good
Scott,
grade eight. Yes.
Scott, I'm six beers in. Can you come Uber me to my sister's house?
You call your own friend. What's your name? Uber.
Hey, can you Uber me?
Uber me. Hey, and my sister texts me. She goes, hey, I thought you said till 11 when you come.
Your sister?
Come on, the funeral started already.
The funeral started already. Oh, shit. Hey, the food's coming.
Hey, I got to do the eulogy tomorrow. Why do birds suddenly appear?
You're going to have your shit.
You know what you should do? Go to the eulogy and be like, oh my God, his hand.
Oh, that's terrible. Too soon.
I'm sorry for the loss of everybody. Right? I'm feeling the pain. Lady!
Wow. Anybody want to read a magazine?
If you chicken out and just have shades and sing and recite Rainbow Connection, we're going to kick your ass.
Yeah.
Oh my God. We're all going to hell.
No, we're already going. It's Jimmy and I talked before. We just hope we get good parking, right?
We just want great parking. That's all.
Hey,
I hope I don't have to run in
Scott,
hell.
You coming to hell with us?
You know what? It's too far to drive. Gas is expensive.
But think about it. All the real estate you can sell. Yeah.
Hot properties, huh?
Yeah. Hot properties.
Everything down here is burning.
I think it's going to... I think we ran a little overtime.
Yeah, just a little.
Hey, everybody, thank you for listening and supporting my boy, Jimmy and Roy over here at Love you guys.
No, love you too, man.
Love you too. Love Big Earn, all the guests for coming. Ryan, yes. I love you, buddy, for coming in.
Love you guys.
Love Blaine, the radio station, everybody. It's been a blast for a year, and looking forward to the next year.
Look what we got. We had Frank, we had Kevari, Scott still on the line for an hour and 53 minutes.
Is that a record, Blaine?
Yeah.
Blaine, is that a record?
Where's Blaine? We had CFO. Ryan was, of course, Ryan was here. Matt came in, put on his jersey. Dennis, Wincel. And then we had... what was his name? Slappy, and then Dan. So it's two. Slappy Gus. And Dan. And man, we had everybody in here. And then, of course, Ernie.
Hey, where's the nearest coin operated car wash? I gotta wash that fucking clown off me.
I gotta wash the clown off. You can use Jimmy's douche. It's in the back.
You're welcome to it.
I don't want to go to church tomorrow and get my whole family sick.
Oh, yeah, that's going to happen.
Ryan, for real, I have it.
Yeah, really, that's what he gave me.
It was one of my gifts.
That's one of his gifts.
It was one of my gifts.
Periscope that shit. Right?
I got it. What brand is that?
It is a the never heard of Natureplex.
Oh, yeah, it's not the Massengills.
Oh, that's a good flavor.
The gal on the box.
Do not judge. I've been divorced twice. I'll take it to tea right now.
The mint one burns.
Hey, Scott, man, we're going to drop you. Thanks for calling, brother.
Hey, congratulations.
Did he get to 2 hours?
Year. You guys rock it.
Oh, he's four minutes away.
Oh. Thanks for calling in, Scott. Appreciate it, buddy.
So short. He's Asian.
Boom.
Oh, wow. Sorry, man.
All right, good night.
All right, you bet. He's all pissed now. Yeah. He goes an hour and 54 minutes, now he's mad.
He goes good night like he dropped the mic.
I stayed on the line for 2 hours and 20 minutes.
What's it say on your phone right now?
What's it say on your phone?
It said like 2 hours and 19 minutes.
It says an hour 55 here.
That doesn't work right.
Well, then,
don't trust the computer. Trust the phone. Trust the phone.
So you went 219?
219.
Yeah, we're putting that
on. Man, you never went 219 in anything before.
Hey, while you headlined.
Damn. That's your longest set. All right,
can tell everybody you did Vegas.
All right, I got the list. I got a list, actually, of all the guests we've had so far in our first year. We've had, obviously, Victor Vasquez. We've had Gus, Sean Williams, Victor again, Derek Murray, Vicky Wagner, Eric Escobar, Nika Simone, John Kevari, Victor Vasquez, Ernie Avila.
Who's that dick?
Twice.
We had Billy Houston, Big Wood, Matt Cole, Zach Miller, Ocean, Miss Arkansas, Rosie Tran, Steve Cooper, Lady, the ever wonderful Lang Parker. Sam Ridley, Bill Kinnison, Ernie Avila, Trucker Matt and Ryan, Andrew Steele, Buck Acosta, Barry Sobel, Carmel Humphrey, Vic and Rick. God, Vic, you're here a lot. The guys at the Goodwood Podcast, Ruben and Dan. And Marlon. And Zhivago. So thanks for coming in, guys.
Zhivago is a badass.
Yeah. He was funny as shit.
That is funny fucker right there.
Yeah. So thanks for coming in. Thanks for supporting the show. We love you guys, and we'll just keep chugging along.
That's it. Let's do this again next year, right?
That's it.
Right on, man. Jimmy, love you, man. Thanks for doing this stuff.
Anytime, man.
It's every Tuesday night. Love you guys, Ryan. Awesome.
I want to hear your heartfelt thing to your partner over there.
My heartfelt thing to my partner?
Pretend we're not here.
I'll pretend you're here. I don't give a shit. I could be a little bitch any day I want. I don't care.
Hey, tell that guy how much
Blow my kiss.
No, because it sounds funny on the mic. But I'll tell him.
Tell him how much it means to you.
Jimmy.
Wink at him.
Wink.
I've known you since fifth grade.
Yes, sir.
And together we've been through things. You saved me going to Knott's Berry Farm. Everyone's heard that story.
Yes.
And they don't want to hear the fucking thing again.
No.
But, I mean, through all the stuff, started the stand-up together, did everything. When we got this opportunity to do it here, there was no one else to do it with. You know that. And couldn't do it without you, man.
Nope.
Love you, brother.
I'm just going to say back at you, baby.
That's it.
That's it?
That's it. That's good, man.
You're the feeler. You're the female.
Dude, I had to put it together. I am. I am the little bitch. I'll tell you all day long. If you keep me going a little longer, I'll start crying.
I know. He'll I would, too. I started to tear up thinking something better was coming.
Well, and I had it earlier when you were doing it. I'm like, Ryan's saying some nice shit.
I just want to know, did anybody get pregnant?
No, we're not Hispanic, man.
Oh,
wow.
Who do we got next week?
I thought you guys weren't doing another show till next year.
No.
Ooh. Are you going to do another one?
What?
You said you're not till next year.
No, I said let's look forward to the next year.
Oh.
Let's okay. do it again. I mean, let's do this again next year.
Oh, okay. Well, there'll be shows in between.
Yeah, there'll be a few in between. We hope.
Totally misunderstood.
Who do we have next week? Who
Eli.
We
talk to?
Huh?
Eli.
Oh, yeah. Eli's coming in. Eli Nicholas, dude.
Oh, really?
Yeah, he'll be here next week. I forgot yeah. Eli was coming in, so we had to plan him after the thing. So, Eli, if you're listening, which you're probably not, you better be here tomorrow.
How do you follow
next
this?
Week. How do you follow what?
This.
I don't know.
This is a marathon.
I don't know. We just kind of like lay it down, and hopefully it builds up to next year again. But everyone here at Chaotic, Blaine, Ryan,
Mark, Kit, Ray.
Mark, Kit, Ray, everybody. We couldn't do this shit, and we are very fortunate to be here, and we know that. So love you all. Thanks for this opportunity, and hopefully we keep doing this. We'll see you next week. Love you all, man. Have a great week. Love Get you your guys. Thing on. See ya. That thing.